You must forge your alliance to either the Crimson Tide of Alabama or the Tigers of Auburn.
Give the ball.
Alexander cuts up the middle.
Up and over.
Touchdown. He's in. Touchdown.
It is blocked.
Williams up the middle.
Go crazy, Cadillac.
It's good.
Sanders.
Oh, my goodness. He's in. Touchdown, Auburn.
Auburn versus Alabama. This is the Iron Bowl. Welcome you to the Home Depot SEC on CBS. Defying protocol, the Auburn Tigers and Tommy Tuberville emerge from the locker rooms before the host team, the Crimson Tide of Alabama. That will irritate a few of the 90,000 here. And here come the Crimson Tide. Welcome you to the 71st playing of the Iron Bowl. The sixth time these two teams have met in Tuscaloosa. Auburn comes in 9-2, and Alabama 6-5. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Vern Lundquist, along with Gary Danielson and Tracy Wolfson. Welcome to the Iron Bowl. Fans of these two football teams will insist, with some fervor and justification, forget everything else. This is the most intense and bitter rivalry in all of college football. And there is a specific intensity in Tuscaloosa this year. Alabama has lost 4 in a row to the Tigers of Auburn. For more on that, here's Tracy Wolfson.
That's right, Vern. I didn't think this rivalry could get any bigger, but Auburn head coach Tommy Tuberville has added some extra fuel to the fire this year. That's because last season, after the Tigers defeated the Tide for the 4th straight time, Tuberville was seen on the sideline with 4 fingers up in the air celebrating. These Alabama players hate that picture. They simply said they've had enough.
Didn't pay too much attention to it at first, you know, but as the time, you know, gets closer and closer, it's almost like those fingers get longer and longer and longer. The last thing I want to see is 5 fingers in my face.
Auburn says, fear the thumb, give me 5. Alabama says, we just want 1. Vern?
All right, Tracy. Gary, this Mike Shula-led Alabama team has lost 4 in a row. They've also had a tough season, losing at their last 2 ball games. How much pressure is Mike Shula under?
These are big programs. There's a lot of pressure here, but, you know, it's the way it goes. You're a coach at a major college university. There's a lot of pressure. That's why Mike Shula came here. Now, you can't have longevity at these major institutions if you don't beat your main rival. You can't go with people holding up 4 fingers. This is Alabama. They deserve and demand better. Mike Shula, you know, it's not going to happen right now, but he has to show his boss and his boss's boss, the fans, that he has a plan for the future of Alabama football.
Now, the Auburn Tigers come in 9 wins and 2 defeats, but those 2 are at home where they have laid a couple of huge omelets, most recently to Georgia.
You're right. You know, I mean, everyone thought that this was the team and the schedule Auburn could take and run, make a run at the national championship. They could have had it. They just did not play good football. They had an opportunity to get all their dreams and all of the things they wanted to do, but they laid an egg. Vern, they might be the most disappointed team on the 2 sidelines. This is a huge game for both these teams.
An emotional moment. Moments ago, Tyrone Prothro in uniform for the first time since October 1st of 2005, when he suffered a fractured leg. Tyrone Prothro elected to bring out the game ball for the Crimson Tide of Alabama. This game being brought to you in high definition television. Well, picture the day, perfect. 62 degrees, winds from the northwest 5-10. and clear skies in the forecast. Auburn won the toss, and they have elected to receive. Jamie Christensen will kick off, and the two deep men, Brad Lester and Tristan Davis. And a note, this is the sixth game played in Tuscaloosa over three centuries. Alabama has never won at home. 1895, 9,000, 1901, 2000, 2004, and here we go with 2006. Tristan Davis. Flag is down. This will come back. Across the 30, there's a flag. And so, Jimmy Johns, number 10 in the area. And our referee heading the crew today from Somerville, South Carolina. 10 wagers. He'll let us know what happened there in a moment. Ah. Face mask against the Crimson Tide.
During the return, 5-yard face mask on the kicking team. Penalty, 5 yards, first down.
Incidental, 5 yards. Good field position, though, for a Auburn offense that likes to move the chains one by one.
Brandon Cox, the quarterback, horrible game last week. He had the dreaded 4-4-4.
It doesn't happen too often.
4 completions, 4 sacks, 4 interceptions in the loss to Georgia. They fake the reverse, give it up the middle, and a nice gallop out to the 47 by Kenny Irons. Jeffrey Dukes makes the tackle.
Little changeup from Auburn here. On balance line to the left. They've got their tight end and both wide receivers to the left side to that way, and they run it. A little misalignment by Alabama, and a positive play to start off the game.
Second down and 1. Deep backs in the eye. Now Brandon Cox with the change. Hand off to Kenny Irons. He has the first down as he reaches midfield. We'll set the remainder of the Auburn offense presented by Applebee's. First down, Auburn. Jawan Simpson, Dunlap, Grubbs, Cope, Duckworth, and Palmer. The offensive line. Courtney Taylor, one of the wideouts. Rod Smith, the other. Kenny Irons. Stewart in the backfield. And the tight end, Tommy Trott. First down and 10.
Here's that unbalanced line. Look to the right now, to the bottom of the screen. Trying to mess with the alignments for Alabama's defense early.
Irons, little cutback at the line of scrimmage, and he picks up a quick 5 to the 45-yard line. And Joe Kynes is the defensive coordinator. His defense looks like this. And they'll vary from a 4-3 to a 3-4. Greenwood, Lee, Clark, and Gilberry. Simpson, Hall, and Terrence Jones, the linebackers. The secondary, Robinson, Carter, Dukes, Simeon Castillo. Second and 5. Lee Guess is the third wide receiver. They keep it on the ground again. It's Kenny Irons. And it will be third down. Tommy Tuberville, head coach at Auburn. In his 8th season, 69-29. The last 3 years have been particularly productive. And Mike Shula, 10-2 last year, took a little of the pressure off, but 6-5 this year. And he's trying to avoid becoming the first coach in Alabama history to lose 4 in a row for the Auburn Tigers. On third down, blitz, Cox up, tip, incomplete. Simeon Castile. It'll be fourth down.
Boy, Brandon Cox should have noticed Alabama was coming with 6 people. All-out blitz. There's no safety in the middle of the field. Look at that Alabama defense. They're all in the line of scrimmage. There's nobody back here. There's nothing back here. You know it's all out. They're coming from the sides. Tries to get it, and, oh, I guess that Alabama defense guessed on the slant, and they were right.
Cody Bliss on the punt, having a terrific season. Skies this one, and it will reach the end zone. Touchback for the Crimson Tide. So great field position for the Auburn Tigers. Last year, they scored the first three times they had the football. They don't hear John Parker Wilson, the sophomore, will be at quarterback when we return. Full house, as you might expect, at Bryant Denny in Tuscaloosa. John Parker Wilson only 219 yards away from setting a single-season passing yardage mark. If he gets that 219, he'll surpass Brody Coyle. And up front, it's Smith, Britt Caldwell, Marlon Davis, and Chris Capps. Offensive line, DJ Hall. Keith Brown will start. He's been handicapped much of the season with injuries. Ken Darby, LaRon McClain in the backfield, the tight end, Travis McCall. And it's Will Oakley starting in place of Keith Brown. DJ Hall in motion. They hand it to Darby. Gets 1 yard. And defensively for the Auburn Tigers. Up front, Gunn, Thompson, Sendarik Marks, and Quinton Groves. Linebackers, Will Herring starting his 48th consecutive game today. That's an Auburn record. And in the secondary, David Irons, Aaron Savage, Davis, and Jonathan Wilhite. Will Muschamp in his first year as the defensive coordinator, formerly at LSU, and with Nick Saban at the Miami Dolphins. On second down, John Parker Wilson has time, flips it out, cut by McClain. He's in the flat, one-on-one, avoids two tackles, and picks up the first down to the 34.
Is indicative of why they could turn this football game. Let's look at it. A little simple pass by Alabama to the fullback. Just get it flat out here to the fullback. Very simple. It's like almost like a running play. And missed tackles. I think the combination of this game is going to be turned to two things in a football game like this. Big plays and little things. And little things right there. Two missed tackles for a first down.
Keith Brown is now on the field. The wide receiver. After the 12-yard gain on the pass play, here's Darby's got a big hole. Looks for blocking help, doesn't get it, but he bangs Keith Brown down and surges out to the 48.
Very interesting if you're calling plays today for Alabama. How do you attack this Auburn defense? You turn on a tape and you watch Arkansas just rip them, gash them for running yards. Then you turn on another tape and South Carolina gashes them through the air. What do you do if you're Alabama? Looks like a little of both.
On first down, it's Darby up the middle again. This time he stopped at the 49. Kenneth Darby had high hopes of becoming the all-time rushing leader. He needed 1,077 coming in this year to surpass Sean Alexander. It has not been a great season for Darby. He's way off the mark.
Yeah, he started off just really, really poorly. You saw him start to get his way about, you know, fifth or sixth game, and now it looks like he's playing like the real Darby.
Second down and eight. McClain sets up to the left side. Blitz threatened. Blitz coming. Good blitz pickup. Nice pass down low, but it's incomplete. Intended for Will Oakley. David Irons, yes, defending.
Excuse me, Byrne. That is really what backfired for the Auburn defense last week against Georgia. The game plan against Georgia was crowd the line of scrimmage and force Matthew Stafford to beat you deep. He beat him deep. You know, Irons got beat once himself. Can the corners match up better with these receivers at Alabama? Without Keith Brown, it'll be an easier matchup.
Third and eight. John Parker Wilson with a lot of time. He'll tuck it and run it, and he's got the first down. He's got a blocker downfield, and John Parker Wilson gallops inside the 25.
Coverage in the backfield, when a quarterback scrambles, there's a lot of space. The middle linebacker's going to cut in, but watch this. All man-to-man all over here. And these guys, you're seeing all man running with the receivers across the field. See, everybody's matching up. Look at all this green space down here, and that's exactly where John Parker took the football.
That's a gain of 26 yards for John Parker Wilson.
Now Darby is the deep back. Brown is in there. They give it off to DJ Hall. He comes left. Gets a downfield block. First and goal, Alabama. That doesn't look too conservative to me.
Wow. You know, this team dropped behind LSU 21-0. And all of a sudden, they found a little confidence running the reverse downfield. You saw it open up last week, and now it looks like Alabama has found a gear downfield. LaRon McClain, number 33. If you want to watch good blocking, keep your eye on 33.
That is only the fourth time DJ Hall has run the ball this year. He picks up 21st and goal. They hand it off to Darby, nothing doing. This has been, as Gary just said, a very slow starting Alabama team, and particularly in this series. It's been 1996, the last time Alabama scored a first quarter touchdown against Auburn.
Well, I read this. I thought it had to be a misprint in the history of this football game between these two. Alabama's only scored 20 points against Auburn in the history here in this stadium. Now, I know that they haven't played all that many times. But when you read it, you got to kind of leaf through the book to see what they're talking about.
Here's the elephant package now. This is McClain and Tim Castile. Castile is the deep back. He gets the handoff left side. No.
Yeah.
An emphatic no.
It's an undersized Auburn defense, so they need to get off blocks. If they hang up on blocks, they get gashed. You can see right there, they got off blocks. Now, this situation before, now, they've thrown the fullback pass to McClain. Remember the one, the Ole Miss game with a pass like that? But I think in this type of game, if I'm Mike Shula, I'm thinking it's four down territory right now. So I'm running the ball.
You can see they go to Castile when they've got short yardage plays. He's got 12 touchdowns this year. They hand it off, and this one does not work. Again, fumble.
Nope.
I beg your pardon.
I'll tell you, the Auburn players are running right at the Alabama bench and challenging them, looking them right in the face. If I'm Alabama, I'm going for it. I'm not going to let somebody run in my face.
I think you may be in Mike Shula's ear.
Simeon Castile that time ran up and said, let's go for it.
Well, the crowd doesn't agree with the decision. First and goal from the five, and here is Jamie Christensen. He missed two last week from 40 and 49 at LSU.
Similar to the Tennessee game. Remember when the players wanted to go for it on that one and they kicked the field goal?
Sure do.
Clock's down to zero.
Flag is down.
Brock of the snap, delay of gain on the offense. Penalty will be 5 yards.
That'll actually give him a better angle at the field goal.
I guess I'm going to have to talk to a math guy about that one of these times.
Well, I'm a sociology major,
I hear it a lot. I guess it does, you know.
Well, if you're looking for a math guy, you got to find another
wrong
bus.
Booth,
yeah,
wrong
yeah,
booth.
Yeah. 24 yards. Hold is down. The kick is up. Alabama takes what might be deemed an unsatisfactory 3-0 lead. Mike Shula. His team leads it by 3. Three nothing Alabama, 6:53 remaining as they had three shots from the 3-yard line, unable to get in, settled for the 24-yard field goal, and the Crimson Tide takes a 3-0 lead. Christensen will kick off for the second time. And Tristan Davis, Brad Lester should be the deep bin. Brad Lester, number one. Tristan Davis, number 9.
Well, as much as Alabama has struggled trying to come up with big plays, if you talk to the Auburn people, they see it's a lack of explosive plays for their offense that troubles them also.
This will be Tristan Davis' short kick again at the 6-yard line. Davis goes left. Block in the back. No flag down. Tristan Davis all the way out to the 35. Ooh, I thought I saw one, but there is no infraction. And Auburn has good field position again. Well, college football lost a giant when Bo Schembechler passed away at the age of 77. And Gary, I know you had a very close relationship with him.
He recruited me, did broadcasting with Bo. We did Detroit Lion football games together, and a big part of my life, and he will be missed. You know, you talk Bo, you talk Bear, there's a few of them, you know, and he's right there.
Well, I was thinking of Urban Meyer's remarks about casting shadows, and he mentioned Bo Schembechler, Woody Hayes. Here's a play fake. Brandon Cox goes on the far side. It's incomplete. And for more on Michigan and Ohio State, let's go back to the studio for this Liberty Mutual update. Here's Tim.
Okay, fellas. Well, Bo may be smiling down. Mike Hart with a 1-yard touchdown run. And by the way, Chad Henne was 4 for 4 for 67 yards and got the ball to Mario Manningham to get it to the one to set up the score. Wolverines have the early lead, Vern.
All right, Tim, thank you. Ohio State has won 18, Michigan 11. It's second down and 10. Cox, this time they try the reverse to Montez Billings, and he is caught and dropped at the 33-yard line. Jawan Simpson, number 42, led the defensive charge.
This should have worked. Montez Billings ran the wrong way. He had a blocker in front of him, and it could have worked. Billings are going to come around, but walk to the outside here. Set up. Now just cash it right in there. He tries to overthink it, goes outside, and runs right into the blocked player. That's a mental mistake. Juan Simpson's not that good.
Third and 10. Cox out of the shotgun. In as he lets it fly left side, and it's caught by Montez Billings. No, it's incomplete. And a flag is down as well.
That's the second completed pass for Auburn out of bounds. They're cutting it too close over there. Start your cut a little nearer the center of the field.
Now the option now for Alabama.
You can see, out right near
illegal
the sideline.
On the offense, two players being moving at the same time.
That ball was fumbled, that's why it was called incomplete.
And because it brings up fourth down, the penalty decline, and Cody Bliss is on the punt for the second time. Having an outstanding year, 45.4 average. Javier Arenas, this one returnable. Fairly low. Arenas backs up, grabs it at the 14. In trouble, down at the 19. David Irons, number 4, makes the tackle. There's another flag down back at the 50.
I think Quinton Groves was in the middle of something way behind. They put a lot of starters on the punt teams for Auburn. He was in the middle of something way behind the play.
Now the tackle made at the 20 and the flags on either side of the 50.
Yeah, there looks like there's another flag way down by the 32-yard line, too.
It's a symphony in yellow.
Yes. There's three of them.
Oh,
three
wagers. How about that?
Three penalties. Pushing them back and offsetting penalties. So they'll march it off against Alabama, I assume.
Looked like he was giving semaphore signals for a plane landing.
Plane to land. Exactly.
Here comes the Tomcat.
Very good. Well, let's see if Alabama keeps it wide open now. If they had a nice group, the first
Holding,
drive got it down
number
there.
Number 8, during the kick, the penalty will be marked out from the end of the kick, half the distance to the goal. It will be first down, Alabama. After the play is over, dead ball foul against number 54 of Auburn and also against number 11 on Alabama.
Close enough. Close enough. Doesn't matter.
Penn, you did a heck of a job.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Quinton Groves,
Jimmy John, there you go. Those guys, they're already ready, always ready to play. Jimmy John's, Quentin Groves.
Time call. We'll return in a moment. Tim Brando in New York. We're going to keep a close eye on this game all day in Starkville, Arkansas's Casey Dick, 29 yards to Damian Williams. The Hogs need a win to get the SEC West title, but the folks in Bulldog Country have other ideas. They could spoil it all and make that LSU game even more important. Let's get back to Auburn and Alabama.
All right, Tim, and of course, the most bitter defeat of the season for this Alabama team occurred here when they lost at home to Mississippi State. Well, 3-0, a long 74-yard drive, second possession, DJ Hall. Oh, was he open?
How about that?
At the 23-yard line, the tackle is made.
How about that? I think that's what everyone has been waiting for around here. Pretty simple. No one lined up over DJ Hall. You got to throw it to him. Main guy, no one there. You know it's zone defense if you're a quarterback. Throw it to him. Right in the slot, can't get any easier than that. That's when you know you're clicking on the right page and you call something like that and no one's over your leading receiver.
DJ Hall is the all-time leading receiver in yards now. He needed two coming in. He's got 1,014 to surpass David Palmer. First down and 10. John Parker Wilson back, goes right. It's incomplete. That should have been caught. David Irons hits Will Oakley. Oakley wasn't ready for the contact. And it's now time for the Home Depot Tools for Success. Gary on the last possession.
Yeah, Vern, you've been there before. You know, you got all these tools, right? You try this, you try that. But sometimes you just got to hammer it. You know, you just hammer it. Uh-oh. And you come back and you hammer it another time. And then you know you don't have a good enough hammer. And that's always a problem. That's my best tool, and it's always the hammer. I can't make it fit. I'd use the hammer. Well, it didn't fit again.
Yeah, I would go for the chisel.
Exactly. Yeah, they should have gone for the chisel.
Second down and 10. Blitz coming. They pick it up. Fires it right side. Caught by LaRon McClain. Tries to break the tackle. Can't. It'll be third down and probably five when they spot the ball.
Yeah.
Tristan Davis makes the tackle number 9.
Pretty successful play, though. If you're calling plays for Alabama and you're watching from the sideline, if you're Mike Shula, we're making good decisions. My quarterback's giving it to the right guy. We're catching the ball. We're moving the chains. Second long, you like to get close to half of it. Just exactly the way you would teach a guy, and he got half of it. And at LaRon McClain, he does not go down easy.
On third down, Alabama goes with 4 wideouts, and Keith Brown is among them. The oft-injured speedster. Here comes the blitz again. John Parker Wilson back. Off his back foot, the receiver slipped. It's Oakley again. So Oakley has had minimal influence in this game so far.
Yeah, it was what you call a smash route, and what happened, it was all man coverage, and Will Height right there, you just knew what was coming. Really, no push right there. Good jobs by Will Height. You know, he had his hands slightly on him, but that's not enough to call, and the ball was really a toss away.
P.J. Fitzgerald on the punt for the first time. Trey Smith, number 22, who was the regular returner a couple of years ago, had some problems, and they brought him back on last week. And he returned one punt for 6 yards in the loss to Georgia. Trey Smith back to return. Oh, my. Smith has to run up under it. He's got it. Good downfield coverage. Marcus Johnson, number 24, puts the plug in that attempt. Very poor punt, 33 yards.
Well, I don't blame him. Gerard Powers, number 8, almost came and got this thing. And Trey Smith is back there. You knew it was a block on the play, so he had no blockers downfield and caught it and just got the most he could.
Courtney Taylor needs 4 catches to become the all-time leader in his career for the Auburn Tigers. NFL on CBS tomorrow, a doubleheader for you. We've got 6 games early, and then the league game, the undefeated Colts of Indianapolis at Dallas. It all begins with the NFL today. JB and the gang at noon Eastern time. The home of Super Bowl 41.
Great, great view in that game, and then a Good story about Joe Namath afterwards on 60 Minutes.
Who is here today, Mr. Namath. First down and 10. Up the middle, nothing doing. Simeon Castillo put a stop to that.
Well, Auburn has a similar field position after the opening kickoff, and they try to do the same thing. Go on unbalanced line and run off tackle with the fake reverse, and this time Castillo said, no, I've seen this one. You know, he tricked me once, shame on you. Tricked me twice, shame on me. Castillo said, that ain't gonna happen.
Brandon Cox still looking for his first completion. He's 0 for 3. Draw play, Kenny Irons up the middle with room to the 46-yard line. Another Auburn third down. Terrence Jones, number 55, and Prince Hall, number 21.
Well, if you're going to run the ball up the middle, you got to block the middle linebacker. The middle linebacker's number 21, right in the middle right there. You got to do it, and this time Auburn did it. Boom, you come off, and you just get big duck for offensive guard. He helps on the nose tackle and comes out on the middle linebacker. Good, good combination block.
Third and 4, Alabama defensively with 3 men down.
Oh, blitz. Excuse me, Vernon. This time Cox sees it.
Yep, here they come. And he throws it poorly out to Lee Guess on the left side. So Brandon Cox, with his worst game of the season last week, is off to a tough start in this one. He is 0 for 4.
He's off to a similar start, if you ask me.
There's the dreaded 4 again.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, that time you got man-to-man. You got nobody back here. No one at all back here. So they try to run a little gimmick bubble screen to the outside. Get a little too cute. See the bubble rub off? Didn't work.
Javier Arenas camps under it, grabs it at the 8. Ball down immediately. Yes, it was. Cody Bliss, the punter. There's another flag back at the 46-yard line.
Well, this is going to be a big call, because if it's against Alabama, it'll be a first down. If against Auburn, they're going to force them to kick again with that spot.
Ah, against Auburn.
Yeah, no, you know Mike Shula will say, take that back and re-kick. Boy, self-inflicted wounds by Auburn. They just can't seem to do anything right. Completing passes out of bounds, throwing the ball wildly.
Illegal motion on the kicking team, number 9. Penalty will be 5 yards. That remains 4th.
Auburn's done one thing right in this game, goal line stand.
Yep. And that was significant. Tommy Tuberville. Team is 9-2, but they got thrashed by Arkansas at home, and then they got pounded upon by Georgia last week. They still have a mathematical chance, but if Arkansas wins today, then Arkansas's in the SEC championship game. Here's Bliss for the second time. It's another good one. This one's too good. It'll go into the end zone, so net gain of 12 yards for the Alabama Crimson Tide. And let's head back to our New York studios once again. Here is Tim.
Vernon, Gary, I want to show you a pick play that goes uncalled. You've got to be kidding me. Troy Smith, a 1-yard pass to Roy Hall. They had 4 third down conversions on the drive. They're tied at 7 on a pick. Gary, back to you, Vern.
All right, Tim, thank you. 3-0 here, Alabama with the ball for the third time. They still have not scored a touchdown in the first quarter in this series since 1996. Freddie Kitchens threw that one. Play action. John Parker Wilson has loads of time. Good downfield coverage. And Darby tries to shake the tackle, but he stopped at the 23. And let's check in with Tracy Wolfson.
Guys, we saw Tyrone Prothrow run the ball out earlier. Well, I was at the tunnel when he first stepped onto the field during pregame, all dressed, helmet on, and you should have heard the crowd, a standing ovation. Prothrow actually was dressed at practice Wednesday for the first time since his injury. He even caught some balls. I had a chance to talk with him, and he told me he's still rehabbing every day and expects to be ready for next year. Guys?
And we hope so. We hope so.
Yeah, big difference. I'll tell you, if DJ Hall comes back, with Prothrow, this could be a scary football team next year. Wilson will be more of a veteran, and the schedule turns their way.
Here comes the blitz. Good blitz pickup. John Parker Wilson, Keith Brown. Brown hampered by a knee that he injured in the Florida game almost a month ago and then was re-injured last week. He's the speedster of this team, and boy, when you lose him, it really cuts into your effect.
If you don't have that, if you don't have the speed on both sides of the field, they can really slant towards you. Now, well, I'll tell you, you get beat for a few touchdowns by Georgia, and you can see just the lack of aggressiveness from this Auburn secondary. I mean, that's a gimme throw on second. You knew what Alabama was going to try to do, pick up half of it. They got 9 out of 10. Where was the corner? Playing way too conservative. Got beat last week. A little bit nervous at corner for Auburn.
Third and one. Wilson calls timeout. Play cake, yes. Those play cakes will get you every time, you know. It's not something you want in your diet. 14 seconds to go, opening quarter, third and one when we come back. Keith Brown, a junior out of Fort Walton Beach, Florida, and you can see how much they miss him when he's not in the lineup.
You're right, there it is. You have to have double width in this conference. The defensive coordinators are just too good. If you only have one receiver, they'll just stack it up on you and make life very difficult.
Third and one, quarterback sneak. And let's see where the spot goes. I think he's got it. Yeah, spot is just across the 30-yard line.
Now everybody says, why could you make it there and not make it near the goal line? It's much easier to gain 1 yard when there's 70 yards of grass behind you for a touchdown than there is when you got the 1 or 2 yard line. It's just, you got to sell out down by the goal line. Here, you always be careful. They might go deep on you and give you a Bart Starr. Isn't it? You know, right?
I remember that. I saw that. 1967 Ice Bowl. Bart Starr made millions for Jerry Kramer. That's the end of the first quarter. It's 3-0 here. We'll return to Bryant Denny Stadium after this message and a word from your local station.
The kick. It is in the air. It has sifted. It's good. It's good. Van Tiffin has won the ball game. Alabama has beaten Auburn.
And the starting quarterback in that ball game for the Crimson Tide of Alabama prowls the sidelines now, Mike Shula. He was 2-1 and as a quarterback, but 0-for-3 as the head coach of the Crimson Tide against the hated rival. And normally you shy away from words like that, but these two, it's not too strong. On first down, here's the toss. Darby with a block. And he spilled after a gain of 5 to the 35-yard line. But this Alabama team, Gary, has moved the ball very effectively so far.
Yeah, for the back-to-back weeks, Auburn is in a deficit. Over 100 yards already gained by Alabama in the first quarter. Last week against Georgia, Auburn was down 200 yards to 35 in the first half. They can't get off the mark, and right now Cox is not playing well. But you can't win these games on the road without a quarterback that's not hit, without hitting a target with your quarterback. I mean, he's got to come through with better throws.
It's going to be a second down here. See the total yardage so far. Heavy edge for the Crimson Tide. They'll try the draw play, and Darby this time is hammered as he gets back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to set up another third down. Take CBS Sportsline with you wherever you go on your internet-enabled phone. Access breaking news and in-depth stats. Get expert video, live scoreboards, and even manage your fantasy team. Click on mobile at CBSSportsline.com. Third and 6. Wilson. Oh, fumble. Auburn got it. Quinton Groves with the hit.
Well, a nightmarish memory from last year when 11 sacks. Watch Quinton Groves. Goes right around right tackle Chris Capps and then almost decapitates the quarterback. Ooh, that is not a good sign. Quinton Groves is the guy you have to stop. He's the sack man right there. And Alabama, short corner to the weak side, and he took it.
See the number a year ago, 11. That's the first today. First down and 10. Auburn has the ball inside the 30. Brad Lester is now the running back, number one.
8 men in the box, and Cox knows it.
Lester gets the handoff, comes left to the 23, perhaps the 22-yard line. Terrence Jones. Well, we talked a little bit about that appearance for Brandon Cox last week against Georgia, 4-4-4. That's 4 sacks, 4 interceptions, only 4 completions.
Yeah. When I played with my gravitas, you don't get to play 4 quarters if you have one of those.
Reminds me of the great Moses Malone line with the 76ers. You're going to win the NBA? And he said 4-4-4. Talking about 3 series. Here's Brad Lester. Skips up the middle to the 15-yard line. That should be another Auburn first down. Jones and Dukes with the tackle.
See it. He's got to change that. But you know what? Al Borges, the offensive coordinator, outstanding offensive coordinator for Auburn. I've known Al forever, UCLA, down in Indiana. He really calls his game off the running game. He's got the running game going. He'll get you with those little boots and misdirection plays. It all starts with running the ball between the tackles for Al.
Double tight ends now. Lester's still the running back. Left side, Lester, slight hole, down to the 12. Well, this Auburn team with Brandon Cox as the starting quarterback, 9 wins, 2 defeats, and look at the difference winning and losing.
Yeah, especially, you know, everybody had been gashing Georgia all year, and all of a sudden he takes a turn having one of those games where he just didn't have it. You've been banged up all year, but,
exactly.
You know, so is everybody at this level. I mean, it happens.
Second down. Here's the toss to Lester. Sweep to the right side. To the 5. In for the touchdown for the Tigers. Touchdown of the season for the smallish tailback, Brad Lester. And John Vaughn is on to kick the extra point. Vaughn, who's hit 30 of 30 this year and 103 in a row. Matter of fact, we saw his last miss. It came against Arkansas in the 6th game in 2004. He's hit 158 of 159 in his career. Make it 159 out of 160. Lester with the touchdown.
They outflanked him, and a great cutback by Lester right there. Ran right by Jeffrey Dukes.
And now it's time for the playbook presented by the Hartford.
Well, it's a play behind the play. First of all, the tight end was flanked wide on the play right here. Okay, he comes back and cracks down. But the play behind the play, watch Joe Cope. He helps Seal and then blocks Prince Hall, the middle linebacker. Seal down, trip up Prince Hall right there, and there's the gash. Run right by the safety. Good running backs. They beat safeties. The play behind the play is a good formation. And then your center, Joe Cope, blocks the middle linebacker. He got his shoe and made the block. Well-blocked play.
And he gets a sky-high ride after the touchdown from Tim Duckworth, who helped lead the way. As Matt Clark is ready to kick off, and Clark has been awesome at kickoffs this year. 46 of his 58 have resulted in touchbacks. This is not one of them. Oh, yes, it is. Oh.
Well, that's a lack of belief, huh?
Oh, I thought sure that
Absolutely.
One was coming out.
Come on, the big football game. Got a chance to run 102 yards. Take it out of there.
Brad Lester with the touchdown. And take a look. Bo Jackson, by the way, is in the house today.
How about that? Bo Jackson.
Yeah.
Joe Namath.
Bart Starr is here. We're talking running backs here. Davis, Williams, Ronnie Brown, and Joe Cribbs. And Brad Lester has averaged a touchdown every 10.4 times he's touched it.
Don Shula. Holy cow.
Got some shadows being cast in here today. The Iron Bowl. Oh, boy. That was going to be a reverse.
Yep, sure was.
And Sam Derek Marks, number 94, said, I don't believe so.
Now, an inside freshman player who's got too much penetration on the play. Watch Marks inside right there. Comes, goes up. Not out of blocking up front. Too much pressure. Marks number nine. Oh, he actually runs through two people on the play. Caldwell could not handle him on that reach block. Got in there and just blew it up.
Not this offensive line of Alabama, Gary.
Well, you know what, Rao? If you're Alabama, you're worried about another 11-sack performance. So you try to run a little trickery, and look what happens. You lose 6-7 yards.
Loss of six. It's second and 16. John Parker Wilson almost fumbled again. He did. It's out, and who got it? Auburn got it. And there's Quentin Groves in the neighborhood again.
Well, I'll tell you, last time he caused a sack and a fumble with one guy blocking him. So what does Alabama do? They put two guys on him. He runs right by two Alabama offensive players and grabs the football away and causes another turnover. The Q is wreaking havoc on Alabama's offense. We're going to review this one, Vern.
Yeah, Steve Landis is the replay official upstairs. The question will become redundant, but how about this offensive line?
Oh, no. Right now, Tommy Tuberville saying, didn't you see the Florida game? That's easily. This one's easy. Can you still say it? People still remember that, don't they?
I think so.
I think they do.
Yeah, I think so. That was at the 6-yard line, it seems to me, and involved Chris Lee.
3rd and 3. This isn't even anywhere near it. Tommy said, yeah, you don't even have to bother on this one. Come on, this isn't even close. Two players. You turn out a guard. Caps. Put another guy on him, and he whacked it away. That one going backwards. Knocked it out of his hand. They teach that now. You come around the corner, and you go right for the hand. Knocks it out of his hand with his right hand. Great play by Q Groves. Can't put three guys on him.
You know, John Parker Wilson has been hit twice and hit hard twice. Fumbled that one.
Now, if you're Alabama, you got to just say, you know what? Auburn got their goal line stand.
After further review, video evidence confirms the call on the field. First down, Auburn.
Good job. Pretty easy. Auburn had their goal line stand. Can you afford to go down 14-3? Got to have a goal line stand if you want to keep that thing away from their thumb.
Joe Kynes talking with us yesterday. The defensive coordinator had our group ready to suit up. He was very emotional. We must win, he said. They need some help here, and they don't get it.
Oh, man.
Kenny Irons goes like a knife through butter.
Didn't even have to be a sharp knife on that one. That hurt your pride.
There's a flag at the goal line.
Could have been a post call, though,
yep.
I think. You talk about gashing.
Unsportsmanlike, so we're going to have a celebration penalty. Back-to-back fumbles.
After the play is over, unsportsmanlike, number 50 on Auburn. Penalty will be 15 yards on the try. Touchdown is good.
So it will be on the try.
Well, don't worry, Joe Cope, because I'm going to show you a good, when we come back, I'm going to show a good play by Joe Cope.
Okay. You've shown one already.
I know. I'll tell you. You block people like he is right now, you can run the ball.
Joe Cope, a former walk-on who missed 4 games this year, number 50. So John Vaughn's try now comes from the 25-yard line. Doesn't matter.
Keeps his streak alive.
He's automatic. Auburn is now 314 of the last 317 extra points.
Watch this. Watch your guard center right here. He helps out on the man in the gap, and then he comes back and blocks Prince Hall. Watch him. He'll reach, block, 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 and then dive back for the middle linebacker just as he was about ready to get that tackle.
Woo. And let me correct myself. 314 out of 315. You deal with
a lot.
I handled minutia. 14 to 3. Tomorrow in the Amazing Race, the teams bring out the heavy artillery as they battle it out in real Soviet tanks. A new Amazing Race, CBS, tomorrow after 60 minutes. From the 35, Matt Clark will kick off. Last one could have been returned, and Javier Arenas elected to take a knee 2 yards into the end zone. May not have many more opportunities because Clark has been outstanding at this part of the game. There you are. See ya.
Just looks like Auburn believes they have the advantage more than Alabama now.
Now let's get on to Tracy Wilson for this SEC moment presented by Sonic.
Vern, today's Iron Bowl marks the 25th anniversary of one of the Bears' landmark victories. Playing against what Brian called the low college, Alabama defeated Auburn to give Bear his 315th career victory to surpass Amos Alonzo Stagg to become number one on the all-time coaching victory list. Vern, you were in my shoes during that one, weren't you? Yeah.
I remember it, Tracy.
Sideline reporter.
After the Bear won 315, here's Darby up the middle. Out to the 37.
Well, if you can't block them when you pass block, you have to establish the fact that you run the ball. The weak part of this Auburn defense is between those defensive ends that rush so well. Arkansas exploited it. Does Alabama have the patience to run the ball at home? It's tougher to run the ball at home than it is on the road because your crowd expects fireworks.
Interesting. First down and 10. 14-3. Those two fumbles led to short drives. John Parker Wilson goes deep left side. DJ Hall can't quite get there. Jonathan Wilhite, who was burned last week by Georgia, and DJ Hall has been playing with a bad shoulder, and he gets up favoring it right here.
Well, he beat Wilhite on this play. It was a well-thrown ball and just didn't bring it in. He could have made that catch. Alabama's looking for a big play. Remember I said big play, little things. There was a chance to make a big play, and you know, Hall's been favoring that shoulder all year. Also, he hurt that shoulder against Ole Miss with a fade pass down in the right near end zone.
Second down and 10. Darby, the motion man. Wilson, quick setup under some pressure. Little screen left side for LaRon McClain. And he's popped as he gets to the 47-yard line by Kevin Sears. Let's go back to New York once again. We'll check in with Tim Brando.
Vernon, Gary, Michigan came in allowing just 30 yards rushing per game. Well, here Chris Wells of Ohio State goes for 52 and a touchdown to give the Buckeyes a 14-7 lead at the old horseshoe of the banks of the old Intangi. Vern.
All right, thank you, Timmy. I was a sideline reporter for that game once, too, wow. As a matter of fact. Yeah. Third down and 1. Wilson clips it. Incomplete. Keith Brown couldn't hang on. Fourth down. Wow.
Trey Blackman, an outstanding young freshman linebacker, suspended the first 6 games, came in against Florida, was all over John Parker Wilson that time, forced that throw a little earlier than I thought Parker Wilson wanted to make it.
Blackman suspended because of an alcohol-related incident in his hometown of LaGrange, Georgia last spring, and Tommy Tuberville had him sit for the first 6 games of the year. P.J. Fitzgerald will punt it away to Trey Smith. Fair catch called by Smith. It'll go over his head. And this one is going to be down at the 1. How about that? Eric Gray, number 36, got down, and a perfect punt by P.J. Fitzgerald. Two fumbles led to 2 short touchdown drives. Auburn leads 14-3. Are you ready?
Toyota presents Heroes of the Fall.
The Iron Bowl of 1985 was one of the most memorable games ever. Every time somebody had the ball, that team scored, it changed back and forth, back and forth. And it was running plays, it was passing plays. They had just scored. We got the ball left with, I think it was 50 seconds or 57 seconds. And well, they were in a pass rush, actually. And I was thinking I was going to have to block the defensive end. Well, the nose guard was looping around on a pass stunt. So I had to block him. I had to actually wait for him to turn so I wouldn't hit him in the back. Now, he still claims that I hit him in the back to this day. But we got the first down. A couple more plays, got it in field goal position, and then watching Van Tiffin kick that thing through in 52 or 53 yards was an awesome play. Van Tiffin, hero of the Iron Bowl.
Toyota, moving forward.
Bryant-Denny Stadium expanded this year, 9,000 seats. You see those seats to the left, and this is to the right side. From the one right in front of the Alabama student section. Backs in the eye. Cox will throw it deep. And it's overthrown at the 40-yard line intended for James Swinton. Time now for the... Come on, Duck. Come across. Thank you. Aflac trivia question of the day. Who is the only person... This is a good one. To serve as head coach of both Auburn and Alabama. Wow. That's a good one.
You know, a Duck was so delayed, I was wondering if he was watching the Michigan-Ohio State game. You don't think he was, do you?
No. All he's right. a loyal SEC sure. guy.
Right,
they'll throw it again from the end zone, and it's caught at the 10-yard line. They're going to give him just across the 10, Rod Smith, number 80.
See, if you want to win big games, you got to have guts, okay? And Al Borges, they have not completed a pass Auburn has all game. So what do? They get backed up and throw back-to-back passes. I mean, you know, you got to have them once in a while if you want to win big games. And Al Borges is showing it right here.
A couple of years ago, Al Borges got a major upgrade coming from Indiana to Auburn. Third down and one here. And that is going to be close.
I think
he got it. I think he did. We eyeball it from some distance away.
Carl Stewart.
I think you're right, too. But, boy, I was really impressed with those back-to-back calls. I mean, you know, this is a tough conference. I mean, I've been watching it, watching it, watching it. And, you know, these upsets are not meaning as much to me anymore. I mean, you think about this. In the South down here, these major schools, what are they recruiting? The guys that go here on scholarship have to be the top 1% of all the players in this area, and they're gravitating to these schools. There's not that much difference.
First down and 10 after the plunge. Brandon Cox will hand it for the cutback play. This is Brad Lester, number one. Lester with a touchdown. He's a little slow getting to his feet. Hasn't gotten there yet. Oh, he's holding that left knee.
Yeah, and if you think about, you know, Irons nicked all year. Brad Lester now. Now, you wonder if they go to Ben Tate here, their true freshman running back, who Lester gets it right at the middle. He's been a real workhouse horse, a north-south guy, and usually, let's just hope it's one of those bone bruises, you know, because he got hit knee right on there by Marcus Carter.
Still down at the 16-yard line. Brad Lester out of Lilburn, Georgia.
Don't know. You wonder if can Kenny Irons take it the whole way? Is he healthy enough to go the whole way, or do you have to come back with a freshman?
Kenny Irons has been hurt much of this year. Now Brad Lester is down, and time has been called.
Tim Brando in New York coming up with the Geico Halftime Report. Mr. Tillman and I will get you caught up on all of today's action, including Arkansas, again, going to their playbook, as in the end, Casey Dick goes 35 yards to Marcus Monk, and they lead by 14. Back to Vern and Gary.
All right, Tim, thank you. Brad Lester off the field with help.
Yeah, now watch this. He gets hit on his right knee, but it's his left ankle foot that gets stuck in the ground. I think it's a... I'm going to do a medical diagnosis. It's his left ankle or left knee.
Kenny Irons is on in his spot now.
That's why I get paid the big bucks on the doctor.
Irons near side. Stopped. Wallace Gilberry is part of it, number 92, Matt Collins.
See, now will somebody like Wallace Gilberry be the you know, Quinton, will he be the Q? I mean, somebody on this defense has to step up like Quinton Groves did for Auburn, and can Gilberry do it? This front four for Auburn, I mean, they just don't rush the passer very well. 116th in the country on sacks, so they better stop the run.
Third down now. Gilberry has only one sack this season. He had 6.5 a year ago. Blitz. Cox lets it fly wide open. Way out near midfield, Rod Smith. Holy cow.
Oh, boy. Remember that guess early on the slant that Castile got? This time, Robinson guesses. Watch. He goes slant and go. Robinson guesses. Watch Robinson guess inside. He goes to pick it off, and there it is. What I saw early, remember Kynes? They had that first stop. That was seen upstairs, and the next time they had a key play, they went slant and go.
And they burned the senior, Ramsey Robinson. It's a first down at the 44-yard line. Irons for a couple. Auburn has moved out now, and the big play, I think, was that second pass in the end zone.
Absolutely.
Got them out to the 10-yard line. They started at the one.
You can't complete that pass unless you call that pass. And, you know, that's, you got a quarterback that threw four interceptions last week, has zero completions this game. You're up 14-3, so what do? You let her rip. Boy, I like that.
And now Auburn, with this 14-3 lead, second down and 9. Three men down for Alabama. Irons goes right. Moves easily across midfield to the 45.
Alabama territory, tackled by Simeon Cassidy.
Well, Kenny Irons, when he's healthy, he just runs like he's possessed. He keeps going. He keeps those legs churning, and he just says, I can't be stopped. He might not be the most gifted running back, but he thinks he is. That's more than half the battle.
Irons with a high ankle sprain in the first game against Washington State, then suffered a turf toe in week 2, so he's been hampered all season long. First down and 10. Billings. They hand it off as Billings comes around to fake the reverse, and he's at the 45. Well, you've got to be nearly my age to get the answer to this one, and you nearly are. So here is the answer to the...
Boy, you get to the 11th game, and everything's up.
Who's the only person to coach both? G.H. Harvey, you remember him?
Oh, yeah.
Auburn, 1893, 202, and in Alabama, 8 years later, 212. His record as a coach were those 2 years.
Right.
I don't know what he was doing in the intervening time. Our research department didn't go that quickly,
probably
did he?
Discovering Arkansas or something.
Oh, dear.
They just have it now, don't they? I mean, you're 2-for-7 throwing, and you're just taking it to this Alabama defense and running right at them. Movement inside. You can see the hole. Keith Saunders runs right away from the play, right where Keith Saunders lined up. They run right at his stunt, and my, oh my. The more Joe Kynes moves his defense, the more he's kind of running into the blocks right now. Trying to find a patch to stop this bleeding, and he can't find one.
The injured player is the linebacker, the senior Terrence Jones, number 55. And while they tend to Terrence Jones, let's go back to Tim Brando in New York.
Vern, thank you. Troy Smith, a Heisman favorite, with another Heisman candidate at the beginning of the year, Teddy Ginn Jr. This is a 39-yard strike. So now the Buckeyes beginning to flex their muscles. The winner of this game to go to the national title.
My. 21-7 there. It's 14-3 here. 2:58 to go before the break. And Terrence Jones with the medical staff out to give him some assistance.
Well, Terrence Jones is right behind Irons right here. He's in pursuit. Kind of goes up in the air flying for it, and I have no idea. Let's hope he's okay. He landed on his left shoulder, but it looks like it's a foot or ankle injury.
Yep. One of 19 seniors playing their final home game for Alabama. And 21 seniors playing for Auburn. Of those 21, 12 have played in 35 games or more. I mean, they really are an experienced team.
First and 10.
And it's first down and 10. They've moved from their own one.
Here's that unbalanced formation this way again that has been a problem. They stack outside and they're getting outside with a little bit of leverage.
Billings starts across, then stops. They do reverse it this time as a pre-snap flag, so bring it back. Before the snap. Now take a look at the starts here, Gary.
Yeah, I mean, that's a lot of plays coming into this. You know, Will Herring has not been playing a lot in this football game. I wonder if we have had no report of him being injured, but a lot of guys with a lot of experience. Remember, there's not one guy on the Alabama football team that has ever defeated Auburn.
Right. Including the head coach. There's Will Herring out of Opelika.
Well, unless he had his helmet on. He did it
second
once with his helmet
to
on,
the
didn't
clock.
He, when he played?
Yeah, he did.
Yep.
2:39.
And they will reset the clock, 2:39. Will Herring, we chatted with him earlier this week, grew up, went to the first Auburn-Alabama Iron Bowl game played in Auburn, 1989, 30-20. Told us he sat in the end zone and remembers it vividly. First down and 15. Play fake, Brandon Cox flips it out, incomplete. Intended for Tommy Trott, number 5. Juwan Simpson was in the area. Second and 15.
Second and 15.
Game turned early in the second quarter. Back-to-back fumbles on possessions by Alabama. John Parker Wilson sacked twice and hit hard both times. The touchdown drives of 27 yards and 8 yards. Second here. Stewart leans up and then goes back to Kenny Irons and said, here's what he changed it to. It's your ball. Third down. Take a look at those. John Parker Wilson really was a victim, I think.
Sure was. I mean, I think there's been three big plays in the game. The goal line stand and two sacks for fumble, obviously. You know, those two drives, very short drives. Quentin Groves is on his way to being the star of this football game.
Alabama has called timeout. They stop the clock with 2:05 remaining before halftime.
Sure is amazing. The first down penalty really changed the strategy for Auburn. They don't like when it's backed up like this.
14-3. Welcome back to Brian Denny Thursday on Survivor with one cast away. Have the power to decide the fate of the game and a romance like you've never seen before. That's Thanksgiving night on a new Survivor.
With the field goal kicker that Auburn has, you're just looking for 5 yards here. You just want to, you know, get a chance to make this game a 14-point game.
Lee Guest, number 25, in motion. Right side. And that one's incomplete. Fourth and 14.
It's a tough decision here for
Tommy. Yeah, I know. I'm just thinking that. I wonder if John Vaughn had. Well, they're going to bring him on the field. He's had a sensational year.
See,
look at that.
I'm not so sure I would do this. If I you know, I'm just going to play it as I was coach. If the problems that Alabama's had on offense, my best weapon has been the pass rush. Might get a chance to come in with a late sack. You know, I mean, I don't know what. Get great field position if you don't make this for Alabama.
53-yard attempt, long this season, 55. He's 19 of 22 from 53 yards out. Could be. Short.
Just don't like it. It's a long way, you know. I mean, now you got Alabama with a chance to make this a football game.
Oh boy!
Couple yards.
Yeah.
Yeah. My pass to Lawrence Taylor was a couple inches higher. You wouldn't have to watch that thing every year.
Retired Colonel Denny
look forward to seeing that on Thanksgiving Day again, right? That's the old Don Meredith line. If ifs and buts were candy and nuts,
exactly,
we'd all have a Merry Christmas.
Well, Alabama's got to get in the game, and they got great field position.
John Parker Wilson finds Makita Stover, number 9. They get the ball out to the 42. Remember now, they've used 2 timeouts. They have 1 remaining. And that is a first down. The clock will stop as they move the chain and then restart when the ball is marked ready for play. Evan Cardwell is into there at center now. Snaps it. John Parker Wilson, near side. Whoa. Keith Brown.
John Parker Wilson's pass.
Well, we've got back-to-back games for you. The Home Depot SEC on CBS next Friday and Saturday. Gary, Tracy, and I and the gang will be in Little Rock for the Friday game. And then Saturday, Greg Buller, Jack, Steve Berline, Georgia Tech in Georgia. Next Saturday at 3:30 Eastern time, the Home Depot SEC on CBS.
You got to be really looking forward to going and seeing Arkansas play again.
Oh, yeah.
I can't wait.
Well, the last time we saw them was in overtime.
Right, against Alabama.
And they beat this Alabama team. John Parker Wilson, incomplete in between the two receivers, Brown and D.J. Hall. That looked like...
He didn't trust the pass rush that time with his offensive line. He kept backing up, and just tried to lay it to a spot. He picked out a spot on the field, tried to avoid a sack on the play. And, you know, as hard as it's tough to do. But watch John Parker. He doesn't trust it. He keeps kind of throwing off his back foot and... You know, it's hard to complete those. Justin Britt was right in his face as he threw that ball.
3rd and 10. Blitz.
Wow, all out blitz.
Stover's got it, and Stover's got an acre in which to run. Touchdown, Alabama. There is a flag back at the 38.
Probably roughing the passer, though. I don't get it. I do not get it. If I'm Auburn, all out blitz, and he beats beats David Irons, the number 1 corner.
Touchdown counts. 52 yards. Makita Stover, a junior college transfer, caught his first touchdown last week.
Boy, Tommy Tuberville has to be upset. That's a big-time gamble. 3rd and long.
This is the penalty, Gary.
Yep, cut extra step and a half. You can see Tristan Davis tries to pull off of it, but he doesn't. Questionable strategy for Auburn here at the end of this first half. You know, the coaches always like to say it's all about the Jimmy and Joes, but X and O's count, too, I'll tell you.
Mike Shula was out on the field having a discussion with the line judge.
The passer, number 9 on the defense. That penalty will be on the try. Half the distance to the goal.
So it will be on the try.
Timeout, Alabama.
Mike Shula might be deciding to go for 2 on this. Very simple. Man-to-man coverage. David Irons has inside technique. It's called inside technique. Look at right here. That's his guy. Get the blitz inside. David Irons, you can't get beat inside. He gets beat inside. Perfect throw. Perfect throw to Stover, and he beats him. But you can see that. He had no help, and that's a big gamble when you're controlling a football game. Again, the late hit. Irons goes for the knockdown, and Stover goes for the touchdown.
2 points, Gary, will bring you to within a field goal.
Yes.
Half the distance. There's the hit again. That results in the half-the-distance call and gives Alabama 1 yard for the try.
Yeah, it'll be a yard and a half. It's half the distance. So now, here's the thing here, though. If you don't make this and Auburn kicks a field goal later, it becomes an 8-point game. So you have to be careful about this thing when you do it. But, you know, from the yard and a half line, I think you got to go for it if you're Alabama. I like the call. I usually don't like this. One more look at the late hit. Davis gets a good step and a half, and that's a good call.
And so John Parker Wilson and the Alabama Crimson Tide come back on the field. They've got the elephant package in. Well, no, they don't. It's only Castillo.
Castile is the running back, the fullback, and four wide receivers. John Parker Wilson back, pulls up, lets it go. Uh-oh. It's intercepted by Swinton. Intercepted in the end zone.
Yeah, Jonathan Wilhite, too much pressure on Parker Wilson again inside. See the pressure from, was it Will Herring that got the pressure? This is dangerous to lay it up because Wilhite could have taken it for two the other way.
Alabama does get the touchdown, however, a 52-yard strike from Wilson to Nikita Stover. Coming up, the GEICO Halftime Report. We'll head back to New York. Tim and Spencer, scores and highlights. Rumor has it there's another game being played today. Not here.
No.
Not in Alabama.
There's a game within the game. There's a lot of decisions so far in this football game. And, you know, right at the end of the half there, the decision by Tuberville to go for the field goal, the decision by Will Muschamp for an all-out blitz, decision by Mike Shula to go for two. That's what's fun to watch, right?
Strategy.
Yep.
Christensen will kick off. Good news for Auburn fans. Brad Lester, who was injured, is back on the field. He and Tristan Davis are deep. That was Tristan Davis. And this is going to be Tristan Davis after two. At the 18.
Jimmy
1:13 remaining. Alabama out of timeouts. Auburn has all three. Well, it's been a fascinating season. Arkansas, we saw them. They came within a puff of wind of losing to Vanderbilt. A field goal that fell just short. Then they won in overtime. Their most impressive win, I probably at Auburn, right? That got them started.
Yeah, that missed extra point and field goal by Alabama. And then they said, hey, let's win this thing, right?
And you saw Rich Brooks, Kentucky eligible. Here's Lester going right. Tackled by Ramsey Robinson, number one at the 21-yard line.
See him favor that ankle as he got up, though? He did not get up on his left ankle, so that thing's still bothering him, even though he's playing. And I like the strategy here. Remember, you still have a little bit of a, fragile quarterback here. Now, it's one thing throwing when they don't think you're going to throw, but it's another thing with throwing and making a mistake here right at the end of the half. And I like this strategy. Get out. You already made one mistake. Let's get out with the lead. If you're Auburn.
They'll take a knee. Joe Namath said last night that he used to take a knee, and
did he?
You never did.
I don't remember. Well, I.
Huh?
We didn't win that many. I don't remember that.
Well, we've reached the end of one. Big plays and little things, Gary said. It's 14-9.
And that's the end of the first half. Auburn 14 and Alabama 9.
And it's 14-9. Tracy is with Mike Shula.
Coach, big decisions. First drive of the game, fourth and goal at the one, you opt for the field goal. Why?
Well, we actually lost yardage, and it ended up being fourth and two. So, wanted to get points, and it's not what we wanted, but, we wanted to get something on the board for it. So, had we not lost yardage, I probably would have gone for it.
And how about the decision to go for two on that final touchdown?
Yeah, with the roughing the passer, took it down to 1.5. We figure, it's hard to tell what this game's going to be like. So, if we can get it to a one-score game, unfortunately, we didn't do well against the blitz there.
Thanks a lot, okay. Coach. Back to you guys.
Big plays and little things. And now let's go back to New York. Tim Brando and the GEICO Halftime Report. Timmy?
All right, Vern, coming up on the GEICO Halftime Report, Spencer and I will have all of the action on Rivalry Saturday.
Tell me that you open your eyes.
Welcome back to T-Town, Tuscaloosa, Alabama, the 71st Iron Bowl between Auburn and Alabama.
third quarter, the Crimson Tide will get the kickoff. This game being brought to you on CBS in high definition television. Vern Lundquist, Gary Danielson, and Tracy Wolfson underway with the third quarter, and Javier Arenas is told to take a knee, and he does. Moment ago, Tracy Wolfson with Tommy Tuberville.
Coach, what happened on that final Alabama touchdown drive?
Well, we made a stupid call and blitzed third and 10. You know, you make them earn it, and we didn't make them earn it. You know, just that's my fault. So just got to go back out there and regather ourselves and play like we did between the first drive and the last drive.
Brandon Cox, 2 for 9, 40 yards. How do you get him going?
Well, you know, we're really not having to throw the ball much, but we're going to have to throw it probably a little bit more this half. They're starting to put him up on the line of scrimmage. We're going to take our shots and see what happens.
Thanks a lot, Coach.
All right, Tracy, thank you. First down and 10 from the 20. Out of the direct snap, Jimmy Johns gets it. He's a former high school quarterback. And it's a little tough going for number 10, the young man out of Brookhaven, Mississippi. Well, thoughts about what Tommy Tuberville just said?
He gives it to you straight, doesn't he? I love Tommy. I don't think he made that call. That's my first thought. but to be honest, his call for the field goal, I didn't think was very good strategy either. And now it's a real football game. They call it the Iron Bowl. Now it'll be a test of iron wills because these two teams are going to have to face up. I expect it to be very, very physical from here on in. It looks like Auburn is not able to throw the ball.
And again, they stay in the shotgun, and Jimmy Johns comes left, and he is going to be hauled down by Trey Blackman. And you hear, again, murmurings in the student section disagreeing with the call. Halftime numbers look like this.
Yeah, and these check marks, the big check mark is the turnovers. And you have two turnovers, especially where they happened on those two sacks. That is really the story of the football game. And really, Alabama had their chance with that first drive of the game.
John Parker Wilson. Back in at quarterback on third down. Quick setup. He's got a man. Nikita Stover, first down. Out to the 33-yard line. In front of Jonathan Wilhite, number 24.
What a nice route by Nikita Stover, setting up Wilhite on this play. Watch him go out and then get underneath. Wilhite does not do a very good job physically with Stover, and Stover gets inside of him, an easy pitch and catch. And when you give John Parker Wilson an opportunity to throw to a guy on a slant, he is as accurate as there is in this league.
John Parker Wilson fumbled twice on back-to-back possessions in the second quarter. He was popped severely both times. First down and 10. Handoff. Darby hit it to the 35-yard line. They'll give him the 35-yard line. The drives for Auburn, 27 yards and 8 yards.
Yeah, follow it. You get Quentin Groves has changed the game and changed the strategy, and that allowed Lester to gash him. It was a very good run. But what's also happened now, because of that mismatch at center, what's happened, I think, is that Alabama's going to have to adjust. How do you stop Quentin Groves? If you can't throw the ball if you don't do that.
Second down and 8. John Parker Wilson's numbers for the day. Modest. Kenneth Darby's numbers for the day. Modest. Wilhite makes the stop. It'll be third and long again.
It also looks that the adjustment by Alabama is looks like Chris Capps, number 72, has been replaced by Kyle Tatum, number 58. So a new tackle is in the game.
And Tatum with unfortunate memories of a year ago. He did not have a very good day in that 11-sack effort by the Auburn defense. Here's Wilson back. Blitz coming. Little crossing pattern to Will Oakley, and he's got some room to rip. All the way down to the 30-yard line. A 35-yard gain.
You know what happens is the bunch here really confused. It was a stack kind of to the top of these three guys right here, and then the crossing route with a crossing route behind it, and kind of gets a confusion. Look, three guys go up top, only two receivers for Bama, and then John Parker Wilson does what he does as good as anybody in this league. Puts the ball in a spot for the receiver to run with it after the pass.
Sideline warning delivered against Alabama. A 35-yard gain to the 30-yard line. Well, this is how they began their opening drive in the first quarter. Big plays.
Sure is.
Twin receivers to the right side, backs in the eye. Darby is the deep back. DJ Hall and Keith Brown both wide to the right. They give it to Darby, comes left, bounces off the first man and gets to the 25. Karibi Didi, number 21, with the tackle.
Well, this is the Darby that Alabama was hoping to have his senior year. Taking a play and not trying to make a touchdown out of every run. He just powers it up there and gets positive yards out of it.
Second down and 5 for Darby. 40 yards on 11 carries. For much of the season, he was laboring with about a 3.2 yards per carry average. It's above 4 now, which gives him an opportunity to talk a little bit.
You know, and sometimes when you get nicked, and he was nicked, he had a hip pointer early in the season and just never kind of got over it. And towards the end of the season, I think we're seeing a real Darby.
Second and 5, a 14-9 score, nearing the 11-minute mark, time remaining third quarter. Toss, Darby. Gets a block to McClain and powers his way down to the 21-yard line. LaRon McClain, the fullback. Young man who grew up in Northport, which is a suburb of Tuscaloosa. And very talkative man. It was really funny earlier this week in the meeting with the media. McClain said, "I know there's something going on up in Columbus, Ohio, but if you want to see a real battle, you'll be watching CBS."
Hey, that's where you got to do it. You're going to keep Auburn for putting one on their thumb. You're going to have to man up, and that guy's always ready to man up.
Third and 1. McClain and Castile, the elephant package, in the eye. They expect Castile to get it. He does. And he's got a first down. And, you know, I think back to the really significant series in this ballgame. Yeah. First and goal from the 3. They tried Darby once and Castile twice.
And, you know, interesting that the first down run went to the right by Darby, but the 2 elephant package runs went to the left. And this time, with the big package of players, they went back to the right. You wonder if Auburn didn't have a little scouting report on them that, where they always go behind Andre Smith when they're in that elephant package. And nice shot of... hopefully a future receiver for this Alabama team.
Tyrone Prothro, fractured leg, October 1st, a year ago. On first down, Darby tries to skip to the outside. Nice little bit of running, but a good job defensively of stringing that play out.
I had a chuckle. Will Herring, the converted free safety, the linebacker this year, thought he had a chance on Darby, but big Andre Smith, number 71, kind of cleaned him up on that play. Now, we haven't mentioned Andre Smith, the big freshman offensive tackle for Alabama. That's a good thing when you're an offensive tackle, right?
Right.
Watch him clean up. Clean up right there. Just knock that guy off. You see, that's what you got to do when you're an offensive tackle. You got to come back and clean up. That's the difference between safety and linebacker. You get cleaned up by those big tackles.
Second down. DJ Hall wide to the right side. John Parker Wilson looking a different way. He's got it. That's Travis McCall, the tight end. Touchdown, Alabama. First touchdown catch of 2006 for Travis McCall.
Simple out route by the tight end, and boy, did John Parker let this one rip.
Mike Shula has decided to go for 2 in a 15-14 game, another bid to make it a 3-point margin this time in Alabama's favor.
He has to chase that 1 point. He didn't kick the extra point before. Now he's got to get it back.
Brown in motion. Play fake. Wilson under trouble. Flips it up incomplete, so it remains a 1-point game.
Boy, he had the matchup. I tell you, you talk about the play calling for Alabama in the red zone. Whoever called this one had the right play on at the right time because you had the tight end matched up against the middle linebacker. Can't get any better than that.
Well, he equals his coach in touchdown passes for a season.
And Mike Shula did it and won one of these games. And look at that rip throw and nice catch right into the end zone. Well, let's take a how this thing happened. Brown's going to go off. The tight end's going to come down here and here. But watch the fullback come in and draw people right here. We'll stop it at the right point. One-on-one, fullback attracts two players right there. And there's the tight end wide open. John Parker rips it in there. Great throw. But the fullback, well-designed route with that fullback attracting two linebackers and a perfect throw from John Parker. He does as good as anybody. When you give him time to throw, he puts it right there.
Travis McCall's first touchdown catch of the year. And a Crimson Tide celebration as they reclaim the lead. 11 plays, 80 yards, 6:04 off the clock. Now Jamie Christensen will kick off. The two men deep are Brad Lester and Tristan Davis. Short. Tristan Davis out to the 20. Oh,
almost.
And a flag. That was a nearly.
From the eight. Tackled by Eric Gray and DeMarcus Walker. There's a
Eric Gray, number 36, with the tackle, holding Auburn.
So how about this, Vern? The last time this Auburn offense was on the field, when Brandon Cox was out here before, was 14-3. They were driving, 2 minutes to go in the half. They decided to go to the field goal. He trots back on now, trailing 15-14.
I mean, kick the 15, penalty 10 yards, touchdown.
8:44 to go, third quarter, 71st Iron Bowl. Alabama jumped off to a 3-0 lead. Back-to-back fumbles by John Parker Wilson led to two touchdowns. Auburn up 14-3. And right before the half, a 52-yard strike by Alabama. Nikita Stover with the catch, and they just scored on the grab by Travis McCall to reclaim the lead. This one is living up to promise. And we go back to New York for this Liberty Mutual update. Once again, here's Tim.
Vern and Gary, a little shake, shake, shake in the BCS world. Mike Hart draws the Wolverines closer, 2-yard run. Remember, they are 17-1 over his career when he gets over 100 yards in a game. Right now, he has 115 on 14 carries, Vern.
All right, Tim, second down and 8. Cox in trouble. Wallace Gilberry gets only his second sack of the season. It's only the 11th sack of the year for the Alabama Crimson Tide defense.
Cox wanted to throw the ball down here, but Jeffrey Dukes drops right in to make the play. Three-man line for Joe Kynes. Watch Jeffrey Dukes. That red jersey is right in the way of trying to get that ball right here, and that's what causes a coverage sack.
Third and 12 at the 9. Again, 3 down for Alabama. They'll rush 4. Cox at the goal line. Steps up, flips it across the 20. That'll be good for the first down. The catch made by Rod Smith.
Well, that three-man line works well if the quarterback throws it when he gets it. 1-2-3 throw. But if he breaks you down, now all of a sudden there's just too much time for him to find an opening in that eight-man front. It gets distorted in that eight-man package in the backfield. And a good play by Brandon Cox to get him out from under that goalpost there.
See the comparison between these two quarterbacks. They both grew up in suburbs of Birmingham. First down and 10. Fake the draw, fire it out, got a man wide open down the left. It's the fullback, Carl Stewart.
Pretty play. Signature play for this Auburn offense and Al Borges. Play action pass, slip the fullback out and wheel him up the sideline. You can see Carl Stewart right there. That's a design play all the way. The wide receiver gets out of the way and Marcus Carter sniffing for that ISO. Got caught.
It was third and 10 at the 9. Back-to-back gains of 15 and 22. And Auburn puts it in play, first down and 10 at the 46. Kenny Irons, the only running back, three men wide to the right.
No safety deep.
Hand off left side, scramble. Auburn has played error-free. They've not turned it over today. Alabama has turned it up, turned it over twice. Don't forget, later in the game, the five-star play of the game presented by Wrangler.
Let's see if you've got a good memory, Vern. What does Auburn like to do when it's second and long right here? Half the yards. Remember those little passes, those five-yard passes Auburn like to complete?
I like it when you ask the question and
well,
provide the answer.
Look on your
oh, yeah,
face.
I was blank. I told you, I deal in minutia. Second and they go left.
Oh, changed up.
Boy.
Didn't work.
Kenny Irons, it'll be third and long again.
Remember that first half when they needed those long to get it back in play, they would go with a 5 or 8 yard hitch pass. This time they try to run the ball off tackle. Should work. Got tight end right there. Good blow up, but just enough stuff up front to stop it. And Jeremy Clark, number 99, did a good job underneath to make a play.
Third and 9.
Boy, is Alabama challenging Auburn. Nobody deep. Not even anybody 5 yards deep.
Lee Guess in motion. Here's Cox. Here comes the rush. They got him. It's Wallace Gilberry. Back-to-back sacks. First man recruited by Mike Shula.
Coming into this football game, Gilberry had one sack on the season. Now he's got two on this drive. But I'll tell you, it's been the aggressive play calling from Joe Kynes that did it. There was no three-man drop eight on that one.
There's a flag.
Well,
sideline warning for
first
the Auburn Tigers.
Of the game.
It's rather loud in here, isn't it?
Well, it's not a library.
No. Remember when Auburn walked out here early? They acted like they owned the place. Right now, it doesn't look like they own the place.
No. Brandon Cox, I mentioned he and John Parker Wilson, both residents of the suburbs of Birmingham. Here's the punt by Cody Bliss. Javier Arenas.
Oh man.
Boy, oh boy. I guess he doesn't like to fair catch around the 10-yard line.
I think that was David Irons that came down.
It was.
Wow.
Wallace Gilberry, Bay Minette, Alabama. Two sacks in this ballgame. Time's off. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Sonic, Aflac, Singular, and by Budweiser Select. A literal view of the sun going down. Kind of pretty this time of day, this time of year in this part of the country. And kind of noisy, Gary.
Kind of noisy. A great scene all through that when we broke for that last commercial. Boy, it was a lot of action around here.
Auburn has won the last four.
Impressive quarterback, isn't he, John Parker Wilson?
Yeah. Gutsy.
Yep.
Tough.
Yep. Smart. He's got it. Yep. He's got the whole package.
First and 10. The Alabama 11.
Hand off from the 11 after the 15. Kenneth Darby, well, this is a very significant ball game for both clubs.
And as we mentioned, four in a row for Auburn. Shug Jordan beat them back in the 50s, 54, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And the losing coaches in that series were Red Drew, the unfortunately nicknamed J.B. Ears Whitworth, and Paul Bear Bryant. No Alabama coach has lost four in a row. Mike Shula on the significance of this game against Auburn.
There's something different when you beat Auburn, and we haven't felt that. I haven't felt it as a coach. We haven't felt it. These kids haven't felt that. It's different, especially for the kids that grow up in this state that have learned that we're taught at a young age about the rivalry and have watched it when they were in grade school and in high school, and then now they're a part of it. And now that the seniors, their last time, this will be the one that they remember.
Holding call on the last play. Mike Shula talking about this one. And the holding call was on Andre Smith. They're the longest Iron Bowl streaks. The nine-game win streak, 73-81. That's when Bear Bryant won his 315th against Pat Dye in his first year as the Auburn coach. And then Dye came back and won the next year. Second down and 13 after the hold on Andre Smith. John Parker Wilson darts to his right, pulls up, throws it away.
Good coverage that time. We got a coverage sack for Alabama last series. Coverage sack here for Auburn. Who's been quiet in this game is DJ Hall.
Mm-hmm.
Alabama offense has not been able to get the ball to their game breaker. Just a week ago, DJ had 8 catches against LSU for 140 yards. We've seen him all year. I think he's got one catch in this football game.
1 for 21, had the shoulder injury, the re-injury of the shoulder. Had 21 yards on the end around. That's right. One catch for 15 yards. Play clock winding down. It's at 5, and they haven't broken the huddle, so they will spend a timeout.
Yeah, that's almost, you know, you can sit up here as a, because you're out of it. It might be one you didn't, might not even wanted to waste a timeout. It's 3rd and 13. Just take half the goal. Probably not going to make it anyway.
Time call. 15-14 Crimson Tide. Time permitting, coming up after the ball game, the TIAA Kraft College Football Today report. Tim and Spencer back in New York. We've got a few moments to spend here before we get to there. 3:06 to go. Third quarter, 3rd and 13. Tim Castile is the running back behind John Parker Wilson. 4 men down for Auburn. They will bring only 4. John Parker Wilson puts it at the feet, and it would have been short anyway.
Yeah, it sure would have. You know, he felt pressure in his face that time, and he didn't want to take a sack. He could almost feel Quentin Groves coming around the corner, couldn't he? That's what I was talking about. Maybe, you know, to burn a timeout there, it wasn't likely you were going to pick it up.
You know, you discuss the attributes of these two teams. I would think in the punting game, advantage Auburn.
Yes.
And now you're going to call on P.J. Fitzgerald, who's averaging 38 per punt. To kick it from the end zone, Trey Smith has already moved up to the 45-yard line.
Nice one.
It's a nice one. It sure is. Sky high. Smith. And he called a fair catch. Yes, he did. And
fair catch on the punt. No return.
Wow. There was.
He just moved him back a little bit. They can't call one. It's the Iron Bowl. You can't make a call like that.
Or as we say in these parts, it's the Iron Bowl.
Iron Bowl. No big deal.
This was last week's Pontiac game-changing performance. Florida survived another loss to former coach Steve Spurrier when Jarvis Moss blocked his second kick of the game as time expired against South Carolina. The Gators had 3 blocks and the 1-point win that kept its BCS title hopes alive. Go online to view and vote for this week's top plays. The winning school will receive a $5,000 general scholarship contribution courtesy of Pontiac and the only fan-voted scholarship award program. And when you vote, you can register to win a $5,000 scholarship for you or someone in your family. Vote later today at Pontiac.com/NCAA.
Tim Brando in New York. Michigan had cut it to 4, and then a 56-yard dash by Antonio Pittman of Ohio State. This was the number one team in the nation against the rush, Michigan. Now they've allowed 133 yards to the Buckeyes. Vernon Garrett.
Good one there. Good one here, Tim. 15-14 here. 2:43 to go. Third quarter. Brandon Cox, play fake twice, wide open. The wheel route down the left side. It's the pullback, Carl Stewart. Second time in this half. We've seen that one effectively.
Yeah, well, this one was a nice one off of a reverse. Now, they've been struggling all game to come up with something. Here's the wheel route right here, right up the sideline. I'll try to keep it in bounds for y'all right there. Fake the reverse. Come outside with it. There he is, wide open. Easy play. You don't want to overthrow that. You don't want to overthrow it. So I do not say this is a bad throw right here. You got to give it to him. It's too positive of a play. And something Auburn needed very badly. They were really struggling trying to find yards.
Fumble. A flag is down. It might be a pre-snap penalty. And if so, this is going to go Auburn's way.
Yeah, half the offense moved.
Prior to the snap, an illegal snap on the offense. Penalty 5 yards. Down remains first.
Let's see. Now, Auburn snapped the ball when Cox was not ready. You see that right there? Illegal snap, and it's a 5 yard. Cope says, I don't want it. I can't do anything with it. That was close, wasn't it?
That's almost a self-inflicted wound.
You bet.
Joe Cope suddenly started singing soprano. 5 yard penalty. And a bump in the back. They flip it out. Oh, that one looked awful from the get-go. Gabe McKenzie, number 83, first of all, bumped into Brandon Cox, and then Cox overthrew it.
Well, I'll tell you, you get down there with an opportunity to win a football game here now, and you got guys running, snapping it, people running into each other, and then there's nothing that Cox can do but just throw this football away.
Cox is 5 for 13 for 115 yards.
First down again. Bad plays. Oh, here's that Alabama look with no safety. They're coming after Cox.
You think he recognizes it?
I think he does. Not going to have time to get it off, is he? He did.
Yes, he does. Toss. Brad Lester fights for yardage. Gets to the 22.
That's really amazing. That was his checkoff against an all-out blitz. Bring in the wide receiver on the play and run the toss. You see, there's no safety back here. It's all man. Here comes Billings inside. And they're going to run the sweep to the outside and try to get out here and hook everybody. That's the play they really scored on the touchdown, but this time Alabama was ready for it. Too many guys at the line of scrimmage.
Lester goes off. They are well within John Vaughn's field goal range. It's 3rd and 15. And this time Joe Kynes has 3 men down. Looks like he will rush 3. Well, maybe 5, 6. He's going to bring 6. Cox in the corner. Man coverage. Receiver open. Touchdown, Auburn. Prisce Rodriguez, number 15, from 22 yards out. His first touchdown of the year.
Strategy a little different down in this game. 3rd and 15. What did Auburn do on 3rd and long? All out blitz, got burned for a touchdown. What does Alabama do on 3rd and 15? All out blitz, get burned for a touchdown.
Auburn will go for 2 and make it a attempt to make it a 7-point game. That was Eric Gray, number 36, who was defending. And Prisce Rodriguez, number 15. 12 catches coming into the ball game for the year. It's on the left hash. The try for 2. Toss.
Going to throw it.
Yep. Carl Stewart, wide open. Got it. Lee Guest, number 25. From Carl Stewart, 22-15.
Huh. Well, remember, third and 15. Alabama comes all out blitz. Vern called it. Three, four, five, six guys coming. Ooh, there's that little slant and go again. Perfect call. Little discombobulation in there. Throw it up. Big guy gets it. And now Stewart. They've been running the sweep this time. Could see it all the way. Their special two-point play for this football game was the gimmick one, and they put it in there to guess.
Freese Rodriguez with the touchdown catch. Auburn has reclaimed the lead, 22-15. Auburn, 9-2 for the year against the 6-5 Alabama Crimson Tide from Tuscaloosa. Longest drive, and Freese Rodriguez gets his first touchdown of this season, 22 yards on third and long. Matt Clark with a kick, very short. At the 10, Jimmy Johns. Oh. Almost.
Jimmy Johns, return from the 10.
Well, we got a nice look here on this play. The quarterback in sync with the receiver. Freese Rodriguez out there, Eric Gray, man-to-man. Now Cox knows he has to throw it early. He's going to get hit. He lays it up, and the offense always has the advantage. At DB, look at Gray. He has no idea where that ball is. Rodriguez does a nice job. In sync there. How about that?
Synchronicity. In Tuscaloosa. First half, 2 of 9. Second half, 4 of 5. Brandon Cox from Hewitt Trustville. Here's John Parker Wilson from Hoover, Alabama. Finds Darby out to the 33-yard line. I mentioned they both grew up in the Birmingham area, and both quarterbacks admired the same quarterback, Jay Barker.
Yeah, they did. And how about this as a little twist? They both had the same high school quarterback coach. Brandon Cox had him for his 4 years, then he transferred to Hoover, and John Parker Wilson had him for the last 2 years.
Marty Rozelle was his name, and Trey Blackman is the injured player for Auburn.
I joked that he got a big pay raise going to Hoover. Could that possibly be true?
Well, I think you were stunned at the idea of a quarterback coach in a high school program.
Exactly.
Were you not?
Yes.
And for more on the two quarterbacks, let's go down to Tracy.
You're talking about John Parker Wilson and Brandon Cox and how they have some similarities. Well, they also both actually wanted to play for Alabama. Brandon Cox did not receive a scholarship from Alabama, but he did say he always dreamed of throwing a touchdown pass here at Bryant-Denny, and he's got his chance, this time, though, in the orange and blue.
Yes, indeed, Trace. Here's the draw play. Oh, man. Antonio Coleman, number 52.
See, it's that part time of the game now where you put your backups in and give your starters a blow. And Coleman is the number two defensive end. He's running the top right there. Stunt inside. That's a called stunt by the defense. Will Muschamp had that one call at the end of the half that Tommy didn't like, but I'm sure he liked that one.
Well, we have reached the end of three in the 71st Iron Bowl. It's lived up to promise, has it not? End of three, 22-15. We'll return to Bryant-Denny Stadium right after this word from your local station.
Trying to go after it. Here's a snap. They got it. Block kick. Ball's back to the 25. Picked up on the bounce at the 25-yard line. And in for a touchdown is David Wagner. Good snap. It is blocked.
Only one of the most famous Iron Bowl games played. That one in 72. We begin the fourth with Auburn leading 22-15. In the 4 years Mike Shula has been the coach here, the Crimson Tide has never come from behind in the fourth quarter to win. It's third down now. John Parker Wilson. Blitz coming. Wilson, watch out from behind. He finds Matt Cadell, and Cadell makes the catch. It will be close for the first down. I don't know.
I think he got it. I really do. I think he got it. It was
you
a
do?
Good play by John Parker Wilson,
okay.
By the way. A little pressure on him. Yeah.
Impressions of your first Alabama-Auburn game.
Oh, great. This whole season's been like that. Let's be honest. These teams match up great, and this game just means more. Now, We've got these numbers, okay? Three in a row losses. You mentioned 0-18 right. in the fourth quarter, one for the thumb, all this stuff. The real numbers is Alabama's able to move the ball, but those sacks, those two fumbles, those turnovers have been the real numbers of this football game because Alabama, it has affected their play calling ever since those two sacks.
Mr. Danielson, nice eyes.
Nice eyes? They get that?
They got it. 0 for 18 when trailing after three under Mike Shula.
Well, you know, you could put away a lot of ghosts with a win here right now. You get rid of that 0-18 fourth quarter. You get rid of that one for the thumb. You get rid of that three losses in a row to Tommy Tuberville. And you put yourself into a nice offseason. But you know what? Auburn isn't going to have anything of it. You got to take it from them. They ain't going to give it to you.
First and 10. Play fake. Wilson comes to his right. Puts it deep, and it's incomplete. D.J. Hall was there, but the pass wild and right. John Parker Wilson told us yesterday that he was a visitor here the first time these two squared off since 1901. That was in 2000. That resulted in a 9-0 Auburn victory. Miserable day. Damon DeBall had three field goals, the only scoring.
How do they get the ball to that guy, DJ Hall?
He comes in the block here, and Darby, they made a wishbone out of him.
Yeah, there's a football player right there. You want to look at a future star in the SEC, look at Trey Blackmon, number 10. One of the highly recruited players, a linebacker out of Georgia, made his debut this year against Florida. He was in the middle of that Chris Leak fumble. He's just a good football player.
Yeah, he was a high school teammate. He was a sophomore when Sam Olajabutu of Arkansas
John Parker remembers him, doesn't
yes,
he?
A running back, and we'll see the Arkansas Razorbacks next Friday. Congratulations to Houston Nutt.
How about this? Third and long, and they're not all-out blitzing. Zone blitz this time.
Uh-oh. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
See, I think that's all you got to do. I mean, you got the matchups in your favor. What do you need to bring extra guys for? They're having to put two guys on Quinton Groves, and they're still not blocking them. Watch Groves come this time from the outside. Put a new tackle in the game. Doesn't matter.
Nah.
Doesn't matter. Q Groves said, I could make a lot of money just playing against Alabama the rest of my career.
Here is the punt from P.J. Fitzgerald. Nice and high. Trey Smith. Fair catch taken at the 20-yard line. 40-yard punt. Nothing on the return. And the ball goes back to the Crimson Tide. Quinton Groves has been a force defensively. Auburn's got the ball with a 7-point lead.
And now, it's time for our Geico scoring recap.
Jamie Christensen kicked a 24-yard field goal after the Auburn defense had held Alabama on first and goal from the three and gave the Crimson Tide a 3-0 lead. Then two fumbles led to two touchdown runs. First, Brad Lester. Auburn up 7-3. That was a 27-yard drive. Another fumble by John Parker Wilson after he was sacked, and Kenny Irons scoots in for the score 14-3. Right before halftime, John Parker Wilson, Nikita Stover, 52 yards. The try for two was not good. It was 14-9 at the half. John Parker Wilson to his tight end, Travis McCall. The try for two again not good. It remained 15-14. And then Preche Rodriguez on third and long got the touchdown catch. The try for two was good as Carl Stewart threw a pass that looked very similar to something I would throw. But he found Lee Guess. And the 2 points were good. It's 22-15.
Take a deep breath.
Yeah. I like those 7-3 recaps.
Exactly. A lot of scoring.
This is Kenny Irons going right. Well, the Tigers have been served well by reversing a trend. In the first seven games this year, they had seven turnovers. In the last three, 10 turnovers.
Yes.
And today,
none.
Nada.
Yep. And again, in the last time we were talking, those two sacks loom so large in this game. It's affected the strategy for Auburn. It's got them, obviously, those two short drives. The only drive Auburn's actually had is a trick play. Will they continue to open up, or will they play a little more conservatively now with the lead?
Second down and seven, 12:32 to go. Again, the Tide with a three-man down.
Whoa.
Whoa, big play. All the way out to the 41 is Kenny Irons. 19-yard gain.
Carl Stewart, he's caught the ball, right? He threw the ball for a two-point play. Now he's going to block for the ball. You watch number 32 right here. He's going to come out and just clip the legs. Watch this. Boom. That's what gashes it right there. Gets Dukes on the ground, and that gashes it. How about a fullback like that? Catches the ball, throws the ball, blocks for the ball, and, of course, he runs the ball occasionally. Not much, though, fullbacks nowadays.
Irons has 80 yards on 18 carries today. It's first down and 10 from the 40. They'll toss it to Irons. This time the attempted block. Not effective. Fumble. Alabama has it. Jeremy Clark, number 99.
Well, coming from the backside, I think it was Chris Harris who came from behind to get that ball. The opposite defensive end, hustling. That's what you call an iron ball play, an effort play. Number 91, watch him run. Boom, right there from behind, coming down the line of scrimmage. A backup in the game. Gilberry a little tired. Joe Kynes goes with his number two guys, and what hustle. Watch number 91. Boom, backside, backside, run, run, run. He gets a play. That's an iron ball play.
Clark recovers. Marcus Carter had a nice effort then defensively, too.
Yes, turned it in, didn't he?
Yes, he did. First down and 10. Jimmy Johns in the backfield. They fire the ball over the middle to Keith Brown. And he fumbles. The ball comes out, and I think Alabama, oh, who got it back? Auburn.
Remember that number 10 linebacker we were talking about? That's going to be a good football player, Trey Blackmon. I think he's the one that gets the hit on this and causes the fumble. Easy catch. Watch Trey Blackmon come and pop. Oh, one pop. And then Will Herring also comes and rips it out. Trey Blackmon was there, and then Will Herring comes from behind to pop that ball out.
College ball, every play is reviewed. This time, Steve Landis, the replay official, said, let's stop the clock and let me look at this again. And so the play is being reviewed.
Herring gets it, gets his arm on it. Oh, they might reverse this.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think, Herring? It looked like his butt hit the field.
You think it did?
I thought his butt hit the field before it came loose. Let's see if the ball is loose before his... Nope, he's out. That ball's out, isn't it? Give me one more try. I'll change my mind again.
Okay.
That one, to me, looked like the ball was out. The first one didn't. I just leave it to the guy in the booth, right?
Well, let's it out again.
Yeah, that was good.
Thank you.
There it is. Let's see if ball gets popped. That ball is out.
Yeah,
I think that ball is out.
I think it's out. I think the play will stand.
I wonder if it was a big hit inside by Josh Thompson that also got this ball out. See Josh Thompson right there? Well, this is going to be close. This could go either way, to tell you the truth. Remember, the call was a fumble. You have to have evidence to change the call. It's real close. Hairline. I call it a hairline.
I'm going to say that we're into that paragraph saying indisputable visual evidence, and I think it's going to stand.
Okay.
Original call. This is huge.
Yep.
This is huge.
You know, that falls under the category of when you're up there, everybody, what, we got 90,000 people here waiting for one guy.
After review, video evidence proves that the ball was fumbled. Correct play was called, correct on the field. First down, Auburn.
No, that first look looked like his butt was down. Right. This look, the second look we had, looked like it came a little bit loose, and you have to have something more to change it. You were right. I could have gone either way on that one, to tell you the truth.
You were.
I was fencing it.
You were amphibious.
Yes, I was amphibious.
Well, it becomes the third fumble recovered by Auburn today. Think about this. Coming into this game, 11 ball games, Alabama had lost only 5 fumbles.
Well, there's a lot of time left in this game, but I mean, you got sacks, fumbles, then you come with back-to-back plays. First, Irons, fumble, then the next play, pass to Brown, and you give it right back to Auburn. Nice cleanup by Josh Thompson. Remember the hustle on the play before by Alabama? There's hustle by Auburn.
At the 30, first down. Brad Lester tries to cut it back. Ankle tackled by Prince Hall, number 21. Will Herring, quarterback, Opelika. Dad is a chiropractor. Will Herring has already graduated, going after a second degree, and he said, I might go into chiropractic practice myself.
Well, he put a move on Keith Brown right there, didn't he? That looked like he cracked his back on that one.
A little torque. 48th consecutive start today. All-time record for Auburn. Second down and 7. Lester almost broke it again. Wallace Gilberry with the tackle. It'll be third down. For more on Will Herring, here's Tracy.
You guys were talking about Will Herring's consecutive game started, 48. Well, Herring says the secret to his longevity has been his father, Ronnie, who, as you know, is a chiropractor. He said tackles obviously take a toll on your body, but Herring said he's had pops nearby to help work out the kinks and keep the pain at a manageable level. Herring says he's the first guy he calls after the game.
I bet.
Yep, don't blame him.
Third and 2. They toss it.
Didn't block the middle linebacker on that one. We saw it when Joe Cope gets up on the middle linebacker, this play works, but this time nobody could get on the middle linebacker. You pull the onside guard right here, and he's going to try to loop around and get him, but he does not. See, it's a little bit late that time by Ben Grubbs. Never gets back to the middle linebacker, and that was just blown up.
That brings on Cody Bliss to punt. Javier Arenas near the 20-yard line. And this one sends Arenas back near the 10. He's going to be tackled inside the 10. Jonathan Wilhite, number 24. Cody Bliss put that one on the line, but he got a lot into it. 54-yard punt. Mike Shula has lost 3 in a row to the Auburn Tigers. The Home Depot SEC on CBS is sponsored by Ruby Tuesday, Dr. Pepper, Geico, and by DiGiorno. .22-15, 8:57 to go. Alabama does have the ball. Tomorrow on 60 Minutes, Joe Namath tells the story of his life in football and the embarrassing moment on national TV that changed his life forever. That's followed by new episodes of The Amazing Race, Cold Case, and Without a Trace tomorrow on CBS, America's number one network. First down and 10 from the 11. Reverse, DJ Hall comes right, looks for blocking help, and gets out near the 18-yard line.
DJ Hall, tackled by Trey Blackman.
Well, we talked earlier about the first time these two teams played in Tuscaloosa. Auburn won it in 1895. They won again here in 1901. They didn't return here again until 2000.
Yeah, 20 points total, right?
Yeah.
And, well, obviously, to win this game, they're going to have to score more in this game than they did in the history of all these games at this stadium.
Second down, the toss this time. Jimmy Johns got some help. He's got a first down after the 25-yard line.
Oh, man.
He was close.
Will Herring took on Leroy McClain that time, number 33. Now, you know you are going to get a hit from McClain. And Will Herring, he was a safety last year, went right up there and just blew up this play. Look at those two. Those two war horses spending this thing together all these years. And they're hitting. McClain had to leave the field that time from Will Herring.
First down and 10. That's Jimmy Johns in motion. Empty backfield. Inside to Keith Brown. He's got the ball and he secures it this time for the 45-yard line. 21-yard gain. Kevin Sears made the tackle.
It's such a fine line from a great pass to a disastrous pass. And this guy's got ice water in his veins. You watch how close this ball came to Trey Blackmon, number 10. There's the guy going to come in here a slant. Watch how close this is. Comes out, throw the slant. Blackman's right there. Oh, right off his right shoulder. Is that a beautiful throw?
From the 45, here is the toss. Jimmy Johns to the 47. Let's make it the 48-yard line. One thing we have seen is the toughness of John Parker.
Oh, yeah. You're going to play in this league. He's gotten sacked. He's gotten hit. He's got a guy coming right down at him, Antonio Coleman, number 52. Get up. He got up. We interviewed him yesterday. Suit and tie on, didn't he? Boy, look nice. You know, that mother used to be a cheerleader.
Yep.
Hoover High School, big high school. Had it all. Comes in here and gets hit, boy.
Lobs this one out. It's caught by Tim Castillo. He surges across the 40 to the 38-yard line. That's a gain of 10.
Corner blitz that time from Will Muschamp. Read perfectly. I think it was a quarter blitz coming right at him. Inside, David Irons, I think, comes. And, boy, is he on his game right now. John Parker Wilson, fourth quarter. I don't want to hear about all this 0-18 stuff. Just give me the ball.
Ball is marked at the 38. 6:34, 33 to go. Alabama has used one of its timeouts. They've got two remaining. Darby and Castile in the backfield. McClain with cramps on the bench. Play fake. John Parker Wilson steps up in the air. That's incomplete. Oh, did he catch it? Yes, he did. Oh, my goodness. I thought he was out of bounds. It's Nikita Stover.
Mike Shula is hurrying up the Alabama offense, trying to get a snap. He knows it's very close. He doesn't want to give the replay official time to make the call. Stover gets his, does he get his right foot in? He's trying to quick snap it. Will the official stop the clock? Remember, the officials can control it and do it from upstairs.
And Tommy Tuberville has timeouts left. He can challenge this.
Yes.
If he so desires. And now they didn't get it snapped quickly enough. The play, we are told, is under review.
Nikita Stover's right there. Does he keep that right foot in as he catches the ball? Here comes the ball floating down. He knows he's close. Catches it. His left foot's in.
Right? I think he's got it.
Huh? I don't see any drag of the turf. This will be a better look right here.
The call was good catch. The call was a catch.
I thought his left foot was in the air as he made the catch. Let's look at this again. Boy, that is so close.
Whoa. Think that's the best angle, Gary?
He's got it right. He doesn't have it yet. Go back, coming down. You can see it's a soft pass. Coming down, coming down. Catches it right now. He's got the ball. Yeah, I think you're going to call that a catch.
The catch.
What
it
great
was called
camera
a catch.
Work there, boy.
Yeah, nice job, guys. Those are two really, really
yes,
good looks.
Absolutely. I would not reverse that.
Nope. See Tommy Tuberville asking the guys upstairs, was
yes,
it a catch?
I know. That was good strategy by Alabama. Hurry up to the line of scrimmage, force the situation.
I think there was a definitive view of that.
Yeah, I do too.
And I think they're going to let this stand.
After further review, video evidence confirms that it was a catch. First down.
The last look was the best.
Yep, sure was. We had whatever we had, stop action, slow action, shuttle action. He had his toe on the ground enough. You know, when your eyes first see it, you think he's 5 yards out of bounds.
Oh, yeah.
Don't you?
As you heard from my lips. First down after the 24-yard grab from the 13. Blitz. Halfback pass, Jimmy Jones. Oh, wow. Oh, my.
Guess who? The high school quarterback. Get tackled like this again, you're going to need a chiropractor. Watch Will Herring. He's on a blitz. He spins out. Now watch this. Does he make a play? Great coverage by Arian Savage, number two downfield. This was going to be a pass. Arian Savage had the coverage, and there was nowhere for Jimmy Johns, the former high school quarterback, to throw the ball.
Loss of five, second and 15. Blitz coming again. John Parker Wilson. That one is tipped.
Yep.
And incomplete. It'll be third and 15.
This was going to, let's go back to the previous one. This was going to be a pass to DJ Hall. Oh, I'm sorry. This is the second one. This is second down play. See where it's tipped right here. Yes, it was inside. See, that pass was going to probably be completed outside.
Looked like Senderic Marks, number 94, got his left hand up. Third and 15, 22-15, 5:24 to go. John Parker Wilson has surpassed Brody Croyle. From the corner of the blitz, John Parker Wilson pulls up. He's got Cadell open, and he can't get there. That was a tough pass,
yeah,
going to his left.
He had to pick out a spot. It was supposed to be a slant, and then Cadell makes a change on his route. He just has to pick out a spot and let it go. See, coming in, and he's going to go back out, but you're under pressure. You got to just kind of lay it up and hope that your guy can get it before Will Height.
All right, Garrett, 5:17 to go. You've got two timeouts left. It's fourth and 15. You are within field goal range. And they're going to hurry the team on.
No, I think you got to kick a field
goal. Yeah,
I was. What's your chance of making 20 yards?
I wasn't sure what they were doing. Then they hustled the field goal unit on.
Yeah.
Trying to keep the defensive unit off, and now.
Oh, no, they're going to have to take a timeout on top of it.
Wow. They kept the offense on the field.
Right.
And then hurried the field goal unit on. That's, and then had the play clock wind down.
Two burned timeouts in the second half. It could hurt them.
The CBS Sports Desk is presented by the new AT&T.
Hello, everybody. I'm Tim Brando. Welcome to the AT&T CBS Sports Desk. A huge day in college football. Ohio State and Michigan going at it. And Antonio Pittman with one of two rushes over 50 yards on the day for the Buckeyes. They got an 11-point lead, but back come the Wolverines. Mike Hart takes it in from a yard out. It's now a three-point game. And over in the SEC, the West is won by Arkansas as they beat Mississippi State today. And in the ACC, Boston College stays in the Atlantic Division hunt with a win at Chestnut Hill against Maryland. Amongst the BCS elite, both Florida State, Florida and Notre Dame were winners. That's all for now from the AT&T CBS Sports Desk. Let's get you back to the Iron Bowl.
The CBS Sports Desk is presented by the new AT&T.
Moments ago on the sidelines, Mike Shula, the head coach.
Well, changing strategy now because of the burned timeout. Shula has said, my odds are better trying to go for it here. If I get it back again, I go for the tie.
Fourth and 15. So during the timeout, having burned a timeout, the offense back on the field.
Do they help on Quinton Groves? Right here. Do they help on him? Doesn't look like it.
Doesn't look like it at all. Wilson back.
into the end zone. Tipped. Incomplete.
A lot of jostling going down there. Boy, there was a hit late.
Flag. A flag back at the 28-yard line.
Yeah, but I wonder if it wasn't
holding.
Andre Smith, yes, on the play.
Holding. 71 on the offense. That penalty declined. First down. Auburn.
Quinton Groves got nothing on that pass rush. They ran a stunt. So John Parker Wilson had time to throw with just good coverage. You know what I like by Auburn? They didn't blitz. Fourth and long. When Groves comes inside here, gets stoned. Now you got one-on-one to the outside. Parker Wilson's got it. Andre Smith grabs, and then David Irons makes good coverage in the end zone. A little jostling, but you got to let him play on that one.
So Mike Shula's team down to its last timeout.
Now Auburn noted, let the clock run. The new rules. You don't want in any hurry to snap the ball before the first snap here.
Play clock at four. Hand off to Lester, breaks a tackle. Slips it out near the 28-yard line. Jeffrey Dukes, number three, with the stop.
Best thing that could happen for Auburn here is not to get the first down on first down. How close was it? Look, broken. Oh, it is second down now. So you're going to get a chance to burn some more clock.
Tommy Tuberville pictured in Orlando late December with a T-shirt that said "Fear the Thumb." It has caused all kinds of conversation for a year. That thumb signifying five in a row.
Alabama's conceding the sneak.
Lester. That's a first down, and the clock will stop. Well, this is Tommy Tuberville. We've won four in a row. That's at the end of last year's game. And here, there was a T-shirt company that began marketing these things right away. Fear the Thumb. Ramsey Robinson was selling yesterday. There's the thumb on the sideline. They're 3:43 away. 22-15. And the clock will continue its steady climb down. 3:24.
So Arkansas's in the SEC championship against Florida. And this game right here is, if Auburn gets one more first down, it could be over here.
We get the SEC Football Nation tonight, 7:30 on CSTV. Second down, under three to go. Lester, it'll be third down.
And now Mike Shula will take his last timeout.
Third and six. No indication of a timeout taken yet.
I thought he already took it.
Oh, he did. Yeah. Okay. Now finally, yes. 2 minutes, 46 seconds to go. 22-15. 2 minutes, 46 seconds remaining at Bryant Denny in Tuscaloosa, the 71st Iron Bowl. Tommy Tuberville trying to join Shug Jordan as the only coach to defeat this Alabama team five times in a row. They're 2:46 away from the win, but now third down and six. Alabama brings up six men.
Man-to-man coverage. Do they dare throw it? I think they run it.
Draw play. They run it. It's stopped at the 35. Bobby Greenwood makes the stop. 2:35 and counting. The ball has been not yet marked ready for play.
Alabama,
and there we go.
Ball with 2 minutes to go in this game.
Yes. And no timeouts.
So John Parker Wilson will have the ball with a chance to, he'll have to probably throw unless there's a punt return here for over 300 yards to win this game.
Javier Arenas returned one 65 yards against Florida International for a touchdown.
Why is Auburn, oh, they're running it down all the way. Good, now take a timeout. I was going to say, they're going to take a delay of game. Please. Good strategy by Tommy.
That's Eddie Grand next to Tommy Tuberville, special teams coach. Time call. Since taking over as number one, Tony Romo has the Cowboys clicking. Samantha Ryan has the story from Big D, plus Charlie Casserly. Quick hits and more tomorrow on the NFL Today. Fourth and six, Cody Bliss booms it. Javier Arenas grabs it at the 19-yard line. Comes right. They try to set up the wall. He's tackled at the 41. That's a 21-yard return of a 46-yard punt. Tommy Trott made the stop.
Alabama came with an all-out block, and what happened, because the punt came off, there was a lot of space. You make Irons miss, and Arenas gets in there in great field position. Remember, that clock will start, so Alabama has to be ready to snap it as soon as the referee puts it in play.
1:50 to go, no timeouts, and down by seven. John Parker Wilson chased, avoids the tackle, finds Stover. They've got to hustle now. They pick up 3 yards. Second down and seven. Under 90 to go. Auburn playing with two men 20 yards downfield. There's the pass, intercepted. Picked off by David Irons. That should do it. Appropriate in the Iron Bowl.
Yeah, misread here by John Parker Wilson. David Irons makes the play. He's going to jam it too deep safety, so he's the corner in the flat. Watch him jam the receiver. Now he looked at the quarterback's eyes. His eyes go right to Brown, and he makes the play. A misread by John Parker Wilson. He knew it. You got to see those two deep safeties, and then you know the corners can fall off on those throws.
1954 to 1958, the Auburn Tigers won five in a row over Alabama. Shug Jordan was the head coach. This is going to be a flag and a personal foul on Terrence Jones, number 55. And Tommy Tuberville is about to equal.
After the play is over, personal foul. 55, off the defense. That penalty is 15 yards, first down.
Tuberville about to equal the accomplishment of the legendary Shug Jordan.
See, his eyes are there the whole way. Doesn't realize that Irons is baiting him into this throw. He thinks he's got Brown near the sideline. Will Muschamp plays the deep zone defense, and Tommy says, better than that slant we got with that blitz.
David Irons, his brother Kenny, running back star of this team. Alabama won 9 from 73 to 81. Auburn won 5 in the mid-50s, and they're about to equal that accomplishment this evening.
Florida, excuse me, is going to have to play Arkansas, but you know, this Alabama team has played everyone tough, including the bad teams. They've just played to the level all year. Good effort, can't get it done, can't win a close game.
And so the long year continues. Years, and there's the fear of the thumb. Delay of game, Auburn.
Well, we talked about Mike Shula in the beginning of this football game. Now it comes back. We've lost 4 in a row. Major disappointment. This might be the worst schedule that Alabama's ever had. I mean, this is a team, a schedule they should have won. I think he's officially on the clock next year.
Yes. Well, I'm not sure. I don't want to put any significance on this, but Mal Moore, the athletic director, occupies the booth next to us in the press box, and they left early. The disappointment for the entire athletic department at Alabama is overwhelming, and the thumbs are up for the Auburn Tigers. Tommy Tuberville is among the least shy coaches I know.
Sure.
He will say what's on his mind. And there's the meeting of Shula and Tuberville and the meeting of the thumbs. The Ruby Tuesday player of the game, Quinton Groves, 7 tackles, 2 sacks, both led to fumbles, both led to touchdowns.
And led to a change in strategy for Alabama. They had to change because of him.
And let's go down to Tracy, who's with Tommy Tuberville and Quinton Groves.
Thanks a lot, Coach. Congratulations. 5th straight win over Alabama. What does this mean, not only to the team, but to the program and the fans?
Well, you know, this is a fans' game. I'm really proud of the fans. Our players played their heart out for them. We didn't play our best game. We had to overcome a lot of obstacles. Courtney Taylor not playing, man, that really hurt us. But really proud of the entire team. But winning 5 straight against your arch rival, hey, that's 4 and 4 straight here, too, at their place. That's almost impossible. I'm really proud of the entire program.
You talked about your players playing their heart out. Talk about Quinton Groves and his performance tonight.
Well, go ahead, Quinton.
I'll let you talk.
Well, man, hey, I just got, first off, give praise to God, man, because I was kind of feeling down. I had some butterflies early. I was like, I knew something special was going to happen. Coach Muschamp called me up and said, Quinn, you ain't showed up since the Florida game. And I just knew I had to have a big day.
Well, congratulations. A great win. Go celebrate. Back to you guys.
All right, Tracy. Thank you. The final score, 22-15 Auburn. And now it's time for the 5-star play of the game presented by Wrangler with the call, Rod Bramlett of the Auburn Tiger Radio Network.
And they'll flank Rodriguez out to the left. Billings to the right. Cox lobs it up for the end zone for Rodriguez. He goes up. He's got it. Does he have it? Touchdown, Auburn! Touchdown, Auburn! Rodriguez, they floated it into the end zone. Preche goes up and makes the catch.
Well, your first Iron Bowl, Gary.
It's been like all season. The intensity was there. The team's played as good as they could play. They've got problem. You know, each team has things they have to patch up, but boy, was it intense.
The Auburn Tigers come from behind. They were down 15-14. They win it to go 10-2 and now get ready for a bowl. Tommy Tuberville, 5-0 in the last 5 games against their most hated rival, the Alabama Crimson Tide. And the long year begins for Mike Shula, Mal Moore, the entire athletic department here at Alabama. The 71st Iron Bowl. Auburn has yet to lose in Tuscaloosa. That is remarkable. 22-15 the final. For Tracy Wilson, Gary Danielson, along with our guys in the truck, Craig Silver, Steve Milton, Vern Lundquist, good night from Tuscaloosa.